This is the Insomniacs Anonymous podcast, celebrating 5 years of hiding the dildo. Today is our first podcast of the year. To celebrate, we're bringing in everyone for an open mic podcast. This includes the usual cast and some new voices you may not have heard yet. We also talk about the Game Awards and Shro rants about how Inside was a terrible game. Find out why, coming up next.
Hello and welcome
to the Insomniacs Anonymous podcast.
It's episode 28.
Is it?
I think.
Wait,
I
have no idea. What year is it? 2028? Is that what you just said?
2028. That's 2028. True.
This is from the future.
This Hello, is time past. Traveling
this
podcast.
This is Judgment Day. Arnold Schwarzenegger has traveled through time in order to assassinate all of us.
Crap. I was hoping you'd say, like, Hulk Hogan has come with the.
Oh my god, dude, Hulk Hogan coming is just, that is a scary thought right there.
You mean a beautiful
thought. Oh yeah,
thought.
Brother.
Oh yeah.
Wait, didn't that already happen?
Yes.
Like, isn't there a Gawker ad and they're getting, like, sued into oblivion for that?
Something along those lines.
I've got no clue.
I don't either.
Anyways, yes, welcome to the Insomniacs Anonymous podcast. It is episode 28, at least that's what I've been told as of 30 seconds ago. And as the first, oh god, I'm choking on a pita chip.
Oh god. That's the first podcast of the year.
I'm dying.
I think what he's trying to say is, as the first podcast of 2017, we decided to make a little bit more special than the usual podcast.
It's true.
Bryan's getting naked.
Well, I mean, that happens every podcast. Wait, it's not really that interesting. You know, it's not really that new. But I guess it is the first time. Well, it was kind of the prerequisite.
This time we have nipple pasties.
Ooh. I think we're going to say nipple piercings because I kind of jumped the boat on that one.
It's like those little nipple tassels that you can spin around.
Kind of jumped the gun on that one.
Awesome. Really.
But yeah, so we have some pretty awesome people. You may have recognized some of the voices there, but a new addition to this group would be Deuteron. He's over here.
Oh, hi.
And Schrodinger'sCat.
First time appearing on a podcast. Thank you.
Schrodinger's coughing up a hairball.
Deuteron's been a long time listener, first time caller.
Yeah.
And Schrodinger'sCat as well.
Sure, yeah.
Now,
okay,
on to the regular
there.
People. Oh, the regular really? People, as you might know, might be Katie Kaboom. Say hi, Katie.
I'm not that regular.
And, well, you know, you need more fiber for that. That's a problem.
Yeah, I was going to say, like, I don't want to know about that.
And we have Wiseman the Wicked.
Hi.
So, how's it going, everybody?
Nasally. Hi.
My name's Starstream. No? Okay.
My name is Starscream.
I panicked. I didn't know how to introduce myself.
I panicked. I forgot my name. I might have fiddled on the floor.
Oh,
I'm sorry.
God. Where's the panic button? Where is the panic button?
The panic button is the stop recording button. So if I press that, then...
right. I keep forgetting. It's the same button now. We just we peel off the label on and on, on and on.
Yeah. Then we have to rewire the function every time we do this. So
it's also a scratch and sniff.
It is.
It smells like cherries.
And coconut oil.
Ooh.
Oh, I thought you were about to say cocaine.
Cherries and coconut
it's
oil?
It's a hell of a drug.
Cherries and cocaine.
It's what we're
going all hand in hand.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God. I just pulled up the notes for the podcast and I forgot we hadn't done one since the Video Game Awards.
Way to shrow.
Was that the video game, the BAFTA Video Games Awards?
Or? Yeah.
Yeah, that, I think so.
The award for best game was...
It was bad, and they should feel bad.
Yes.
The whole thing.
Except
and
for Overwatch
talk about
and
that.
Doom. I agree with those placements.
I have no idea what you guys are talking about.
There was a Game Awards show, and Overwatch won Game of the Year.
Oh, nice! That's
Doom won another award. I forget what it was, but they won a thing, and Inside... won a different award.
No!
And Shro's,
no,
yeah.
No.
Whoa. Step away from the mic a little bit there.
Yeah.
Worst game 2016.
Inside sounds like what? You're sucking the mic.
It does sound like you're kind of deep throating the microphone.
Yeah, please don't you throw the mic. You're overshadowing everyone else in the feed.
Listen, dude, well, your penis is overshadowing
just because I can fit the microphone that is bigger in my mouth and you guys can't.
Okay, don't challenge me, okay, girl.
Oh, snap.
Shots fired. Oh,
shit.
So if you haven't figured it out or any listeners, this is an open mic podcast. We're actually recording it in two parts because we want to make sure everybody gets a chance to be online. So if you, by some strange miracle, happen to hear about this between this recording and the next, feel free to pop in the next one. Or, you know, if you happen to be stalking my window right now and hear about it, then, you know, just log in right now. Also, if you're outside my window stalking me, give me that handy you owe me. God damn it, you asshole.
But I don't want to give it to you. I want to keep it.
Can I have it?
Handy asshole.
Can I have it? So it's kind of an improv show. We've got a few little notes, and you know, a bit has happened. We kind of took a mildly expected but unannounced holiday break, as clearly we haven't updated anything in a few weeks. So we have me, Bryan Dude. We also are joined by Katie Kaboom and WizemanTheWicked. We have a few others that might be able to join us in a little bit. We'll see. And we'll go from there, and you'll hear about part two as we splice it all together a little bit later. First off, though, how was everybody's holiday?
It was pretty good. I don't quite remember what happened.
Probably for the best. Drunk.
I mean, when is that not the case? I'm not sober right now. But in any case, it was a good one. I can't complain on my end. You know, did a lot of... Well, not a lot of, but I did get some gaming time in, actually, more than usual. So that was kind of cool. Yeah, how was everyone else's?
Mine was pretty good. First.
Okay, fine. Going down the list, so yeah.
Yeah, anyway. Then Katie will go, Shro, and then me.
Okay.
This works.
Anyway, mine's been pretty good. To put a mellow note on, it's the first holiday I've had without my grandmother, so...
I'm sorry to hear that, man.
What happened? She passed away in November.
Oh, man, I'm sorry to hear that.
Sucks. So,
yeah, man. So, like, the family time, though, it was, I guess you guys just had a nice family dinner kind of thing.
Yeah, we had a great time.
That's good.
Katie, how about you?
I had Christmas at my mom's.
Oh, are we really surprised?
Did you enjoy it?
Every weekend, but no, this time I worked from 5 in the morning all the way till 9 p.m. to get everything perfect for the family.
Damn.
Well, my brothers weren't going to do shit.
Well, I can't help you there.
They have kids, you know. They have lives. They're too busy, so it's up to me. And then 2 days later, I visited my dad.
Good deal.
Nice. Sweetness.
I was violently ill for Christmas, and I slept through New Year's, so... That was my holiday, but I still had a blast in post-mortem for both. So I have also, and I might be breaking it out, collected myself a good number of new beers to try, and perhaps the best tequila I have ever had. Milagro tequila, if you can get it. Oh, it's so fucking good. My sister, who doesn't even drink, sniffed it and was like, it literally smells smooth. Like, I didn't think that was an adjective that could be used with smells, but it smells that way. I'm like, and it is.
Okay, that's like how... Have any of you ever had black water?
No.
Okay. So
this sounds like a euphemism for a...
So black water is water, but that's just black. And it's black because of some sort of, like... chemical, but like it's not like a soda or anything, or it doesn't taste any different.
Is it alcohol?
What? No, it's just regular water.
Well, but what's the point?
We're
still going really hard with the drug theory. You're not making this any better.
I'm explaining this, okay?
And you're not making it better.
Me and my brother decided to get one, and we both had it, and we're like, the only way we can describe this is smooth water. And I'm getting that's like. It's the same kind of thing with the smelling thing. You don't know how that makes sense, but that's how you explain it.
Because the English language lacks words, which is a scary thought when you think about how many words are in the English language. Hey, it could be freaking China, where the same word spelled the same way has like six different meanings depending on how you enunciate the syllable.
And as we all know, enunciating syllables is prime.
Like my favorite one, I don't even remember the word anymore, but the word for mom, if pronounced slightly differently, means fucker. I'm wondering how many tourists trying to sound fancy have horrendously insulted somebody.
It's like
this is how all Chinese street fights actually start.
That's exactly how. There's no other reasoning. None whatsoever.
None whatsoever.
So is it my turn? Was there any more?
Yeah.
Okay, my turn.
Spew the words.
So I will. Have you heard the good word? I almost said Lord, but like twice.
Have you heard the good Lord? Nope, those don't exist. Sorry, buddy.
If you haven't noticed, I slur a lot. I also forgot to get water, and I had a hot chocolate earlier, so my mouth is very, very dry right now. I may leave
chocolate is delicious.
It is. It was, especially because it was at Dunkin', so it was a salted caramel hot chocolate. But they didn't have any whipped cream, which I was really mad at.
Boo.
But, yes. Mine was good. Basically, we just did the normal, like, go to my aunt's house, party there, and then once we're done with that, like, we just all go home. And then we went to, then for New Year's, we just all stay up until 12, have like a bit of a sparkling cider, and then go to bed. And it was not much. My brother actually protested, like, not protested in a serious way, but he jokingly protests everything now. So he jokingly protested New Year's. He was trying to sleep before 12.
Yeah.
So yeah, that was my holiday. That was my holiday. So yeah.
Very nice. Very nice.
I did almost break my entire chest while skiing right before New Year's. So
not like much fun.
Well, no, it was very fun. But like because what happened was I'm like an intermediate skier. So I was going down not Black Diamond. What's before? I think it's a double yellow. I can't remember.
Something
around that.
Square.
Yeah, square. It's yellow square. I'm not like an expert. But I've gone a couple times, and this was at Killington. For anyone that goes to Killington, is a great place. Well, for anyone that doesn't know about Killington, but actually, I think I think the contest for the Women's Olympics was at, yeah, because I went there. It was at Killington, in October. So, what happened was I was going down the hill, or mountain rather. Why did I say hill? And one of my poles got stuck on a ramp. So I got flung forward, chest first, hit the ground. I thought I coughed up blood, but it ended up just being chocolate from the waffle, chocolate-covered waffle I had earlier. I was like,
chocolate-covered waffle.
They are
great. That's amazing.
They are so great. But it was like, did I just like completely destroy my liver or something? I have no idea what's going on.
Let me tell you something, son. If you managed to cough up blood from your liver, you really fucked up. Because your liver's not supposed to be in your lungs where you can cough it up.
I'm not that good at biology, so meh.
Nah.
So yeah, I almost killed myself, and I had a boring week. I also forgot my boots, so I had to pay like $40 while I was up there, and I only brought $40.
I remember I went skiing one time and was with my friend Tom when we were probably 10-ish or so, like late preteens, 10, 13, I don't know. And I had a guest pass with him. His family had like actual passes. Never been skiing before in my life. Went down the bunny slope like the second or third time. And I went to turn and, or like brake using the like V thing on the skis.
Pizza. Pizza. It's called pizza. French fry.
Okay. And I like overextended and fell. So I fell with the skis, like the toe ends pointing into each other, but my legs were flat on the ground, and the length of the skis and my own legs prevented me from like being able to twist and get back up. Cause like the one leg was like really awkwardly twisted backwards so that, you know, like putting any sort of weight on it like hurt, because I was like borderline dislocating my knee in the process. And so I had to like get help from one of the ski people. And at the same time, my friend and his parents are like really confused as to why I can't get up and what's going on. So it like became this whole big chant or like big scene about it, just trying to get me to stand back up again. And I'd never been invited skiing since.
See, everyone has a bad time their first time skiing. Like, the first time I went skiing, I got a boot that was a size too small. The thing was, you need to get the exact right size, because if you don't, your feet will swell. And my feet swelled so much that I had to, like, pry my foot out. Like, I was literally getting my hands in and, like, pulling my foot. And what ended up happening was I needed to now get a size twice, like, up from my normal size, because my foot was so swelled. So I did that, and I, once my foot swelled down again, now my feet are like, have so much wiggle room that I have to bend all of my body to turn.
Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle.
Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Dun, 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 dun. I should stop.
I like, nah, to keep going, it's fine.
I do too! Wow, I'm finally not the only one.
Woo, high five!
Yay!
So
they just had a moment. They bonded so hard.
Yay.
It's like fucking super glue all over this place now.
That's not glue.
No, I'm too old for him.
Katie, we know you're a cougar.
Meow. You're furry.
So,
don't leave him alone.
Speaking of holidays, I got nothing. So, Nostalaris, or now called Elysium, or Elysium, some people say it differently. I know many of us are actually playing on that.
I mean,
and I actually registered not one, but two characters for World of Warcraft, which is really amazing for me because I haven't done anything since.
Are they both Tauren?
Of course. I mean, I was actually pretty convinced to go Worgen or possibly,
but you can't be Worgen.
Pandas.
I mean,
yeah, that's retail Pandas. WoW or Pandaria.
Yeah, you can't.
Yeah. I was gonna say, I can't do that on vanilla WoW.
No.
So, Tauren it was.
Yep.
On the other hand, I have a really sexy lady Tauren.
Does her booty stick up to here?
No.
Her breasticles, can breasticles you even change do, that? Though.
Like, the settings for character creation were so bland. I'm like, oh, right, yeah, it was 2004.
Okay.
Yeah, exactly. Back then, it's like,
so,
are you a class that has the succubus smacking her ass?
What?
No, he's a warrior.
Is that the warlock, right?
That's a warlock. Yeah, I don't warlock think Torrance can be to. I don't
no,
think
No, I think they can't.
Is available. Torrance.
Well, he's just gonna have to make a third character just so he can see the succubus slap her ass.
Or we can find Whirly in game and then.
True, she can we know she has one.
Yeah, she definitely has
okay,
one.
Okay, so to get my nerd on, okay, like cracking all my knuckles and everything. Okay,
I'm using
that's not Steve. Nerdy. That's just weird.
No, my so the nerdy part is coming. So
oh, wow.
Oh baby,
that's why you put the towel down already by the door, right?
Yeah, totally. That's the exact reason. But
I think we need to subtitle this podcast Sexual Frustration.
Well, I'll make a note of it.
Wild for everyone. Except Squall.
Anyway, sorry. Go ahead, Wise.
Yes, my nerdiness is in the fact of character creation. I am so torn on this because the thing is, character creation, I hate it when character creation has so limited options, but I understand why it has to have so many limited options, because you have to work with the same rig for so many different models And when you replace a model for, like, using the same rig, that can break the model. I have done it so many times, and it never ends up well. That nerd rant over.
This is the first time I met you, but I think I'm gonna like you.
Same here. I don't know why I said
you gotta actually, you know, hang out, Katie.
Yeah.
I had been away for a while playing games that no one else plays with me anymore. And so, you know, we're all going back to the game we played 5 years ago. Yay.
I only play like Rocket League and Resident Evil 4 right now.
Well, speaking of Rocket League,
I haven't played Rocket League in like a month.
I have a controller now. I'm tempted to try Rocket League.
I haven't played it in like a month either, but that's because I left both my controllers at a friend's house.
Ooh.
And my friend just gifted me Nights into Dreams. And I really want. Have you never heard of. Oh, that's actually where my username comes from. So, Nights into Dreams is a Saturn game that was made by Sonic Team. It's. Have you ever heard of the Circus Delay? Or not Delay.
Cirque du Soleil.
The Circus I've Delay.
Cirque du Soleil.
All the people in Quebec are now going to be like, what the fuck did you just call them?
But, basically, it's a game where you, fly as a character that looks like he was from the Circus Delay, and he, and, well, it's not he or she, it's neither gender.
You keep going.
Sorry, I tangent a lot. Anyways,
don't worry, I'll steal you clear. No one else will do it to me, so I might as well do it to somebody else.
It's true.
So you fly around and you have to get enough blue orbs in enough time to break a capsule. But
I feel like I've seen this before. Like I feel like I know the cartridge.
And then you have to get back into the your starting zone. But the thing is, if you do it so slow and get so little points, you get an F ranking and you get a worse boss like to play against. But if you get higher ranking, the music gets more upbeat and you also
What's the name of the game?
Nights into Dreams.
Okay.
There's also one for the Wii. I haven't played that one called Night's Journey of Dreams, but I hear it's not like the original. It's kind of different, but some people like it. I don't know. I haven't played it. I just really like the original. I actually played it for the Saturn before. I usually play it on the Xbox, but now I want to try it on the PC because I have it, and it feels like it'd be great on a PC.
Oh, you know where I've heard of this? Now I figured it out. Overclockedremix.com.
Probably. That I've been introduced to many a game through there.
So I missed something.
What'd you miss?
You said that you couldn't decide on a character to be, and then I didn't hear which one you decided in World of Warcraft.
Who?
Oh, no. I gotcha. We were talking about character creation and, you know, how it's a big part for Wise, and I'll actually jump in on that, too. For me, one of the reasons I have only two characters in Guild Wars 2, I mean, one character, yes, the other doesn't exist, is because I nitpick my character creation so heavily that in, like, Guild Wars, I think when I first created my character, I spent 25 to 30 minutes in the character creation screen.
That's normal.
And then
isn't it?
Elder Scrolls Online, when I was beta testing it, I think I was in there for like 45 minutes to an hour.
What about
You beta tested that? My brother did too.
Yep. It was super cool, and I'm sad that they didn't take our advice as a collective, because we basically told them, this is super well done. It looks really good. It's definitely got the right, you know, path to it. But aside from a few maps, it's not polished enough. It feels empty, and therefore it kind of takes away from the grandiose feeling of the Elder Scrolls games that everybody loves so much. You guys should spend another 6 months or so just filling in your maps and your quest lines and all sorts of stuff like that, just to give it that extra oomph. And they ignored us, and the game flopped on launch because of it. And now they've spent the last year and a half, 2 years or so, adding in content, adding in more to those maps. And now from what I hear, it's actually kind of where it should have been. But, you know, the ship has sailed for the most part. But we'll see. I'm actually hoping to get back into it along with a few other things here soon.
I've never been able to get into any type of MMO. Never.
It's kind of a thing that, like, for the longest time, I wouldn't just straight up wouldn't do MMOs because I'm like, I am a very easy to addict person for things like that. And I knew it was going to be terrible if I ever got into one. And then, like, that's why I wouldn't join WoW, especially with the prescription, the subscription. It feels like it's a prescription. I couldn't bother with sub fees, which was the norm for a while. And then Guild Wars came around. You buy it once, no sub fee. But I still didn't want to really get into that right away because I knew, you know, like, this is going to be a one-way trip and a slippery slope. And so it took me about, 2 years before I finally got convinced to try Guild Wars 2. And, of course, it was my furriness that was my Achilles heel. That and just loving good lore and kind of having a military-esque mind. Because Katie, I'm pretty sure it was, linked me the Wikipedia page on Guild Wars, the Guild Wars 2 wiki, about the Char. That was just like, hey, remember that there's Guild Wars 1, and then there's a whole bunch of expansions and a whole bunch of backstory and books that we wrote too that basically give this, you know, 2 hour some worth of heavy reading of the Char backstory. And so one night I just fucking binged on it because somebody linked it to me and I played the Wikipedia game through it. And I bought the game the next day.
And then now no one
plays. And now I have 3,000 hours in the damn game and I'm a commander in World versus World.
3,000?
Yes.
Well, nothing. I got 4,000.
On one character.
Ugh. I can't. Ugh. I can barely spend an hour playing a game. I'm a gamer, but I'm one of those people that can only play for short.
You're my fucking fix, man. Tap that in the veins, get that in there. Oh, jam it in there. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. The gaming drugs, they're so good.
I don't get how people can invest so much time into a video game. People have tried to do it, like, with me, like, get me into long hour gaming sessions. And I'm like, I just can't. I need to play it, like, an hour a time. That's it.
Well, that's healthier for you, but I mean, there's only certain games you can really get that much into. You either like it or you don't. And when you like it, then you can spend so many hours in it.
No,
part of it's, I think, kind of what you enjoy about it and what it offers you, too. Because I'm a completionist and a mild perfectionist. So, like, right now, everybody's after me because I'm basically avoiding playing other games to play Deus Ex Mankind Divided. Because I'm really, really enjoying it. And there's a lot of side quests and other things to do with it. And I've seen negative reviews about it saying the game is too short, that the main plot is, you know, a little rushed and all this here. To be honest, I can't comment much on that. But I can say that I've spent over 30 hours in the game and I hadn't left the main city level 1 encounter area because I've just done that many side things. I've explored all the things and I continue to find more things. So if it's there, I'll do it if I like doing it. But if it's a game like Sonic, which, sorry to harp on Sonic, I've never got into Sonic games, where like you play the main storyline once and then really all you can do is just try and sit there and do time attack mode. You know, grind it over and over. That doesn't keep my interest, but it does keep other people's interest. So it's what you're about. Like in Guild Wars 2 for me, there's a mothering fuck ton of content because it's an MMO. And I got in, like I started to get a little stale with the, you know, general player versus environment kind of content. And then I got into the player versus player and then the world versus world game modes where kind of the players are generating some of the content with their interactions, and the fact that part of it you can just go into it. So that's where I was getting all of my effort and putting time into it.
I've never been able to be like investing. I actually really like Sonic, but the reason because of that is because I can just like, there's an end goal, just get to the goal, and that's all I do. I'm a very like, get, like, finish this, like, don't complete it, just finish kind of person. That's why it's very difficult for me to find like small details whenever I do art, like whenever I look in my older art, I always see like there's missing parts everywhere, but I don't know exactly what to do to improve it.
You're a perfectionist.
No, I'm not a perfectionist. That's the problem.
Oh. Well, it sounds like
what?
Okay.
So now he's just in denial.
Me, when I'm playing a game, I have a hard time deciding on what character to be, so I gotta try everything. And this annoys people because they're like, well, you made like 100 characters and you haven't leveled. I'll tell you, World of Warcraft, the limit is 10 characters. I hate Spambot.
Who doesn't? Have you ever just like had a bot like try to talk to you and you just try and mess with it?
I do that with the telemarketing robots. Did you know that you can actually make the telemarketing robot sad and it will hang up on you?
Oh,
really? You gotta teach us your ways.
That just broke my heart. That's cute.
I've just legit called out the telemarketing robots and they'll start responding with, "What? No, I am a real person." And stuff like that. And then if you keep doing it, it just like there's long pauses and then it'll hang up.
Oh, that's so sad, adorable, and cute. That melted my heart.
Aww. Also, similarly, if you call into like tech support and you get the robo like secretary, if you will, or receptionist kind of thing. If you start cursing at it and screaming, like, without letting it reply to anything, it'll just immediately connect you to a person.
Yeah, oh, I know that rule. Like, that's, like, every time I need to get, like, someone and there's a bot, I just start shouting.
Yeah. Well, the trick that you can also use is I'll just take it to speakerphone and then pull up the keypad on my phone and then just use like all four fingers to just start spamming numbers into it. And if you do that, it just overloads it and it's like, fuck you, real person, go, just get out. I don't want to deal with you.
I'm learning.
So yeah, the ways you can do it. I'll even sit there like my internet's out or something. I'll try to sit there like, oh yeah, this is my account number. Okay, you haven't told me that there's an outage in my area yet. What are you having problems with? Say, internet. Okay, internet, blah, blah, blah. And still go back and forth or whatever. And I spent like 5 minutes and I'm like, okay, I'm done. Just 0000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000
Yeah, sometimes that doesn't work though, and then they just hang up on you.
I also using the same. I like using the same tactic on actual people that are calling you as telemarketers. Hello, this is person selling you a thing. And then beep 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 beep. Hello, beep 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 beep. Hello, beep 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 beep. Is anybody beep 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 beep? Okay, back. Click. There was one guy that I also had. He was trying to reach somebody in my family that is literally not able to use the phone. It's long story short, that's just what it is. They will never be able to speak on the phone. They can't speak anymore. And so they were trying to talk to this person and this person only. They would not tell me who they were. They would not tell me who they were calling for. They just said, is so-and-so there? I'm like, no. I can leave a message and get back to you if you like. No, I'd really like to talk to so-and-so. Okay. You can't do that. Well, when could I call back? Or could you give me another number to call them? No, there is no way to reach them. Okay, well, why not? Can I just talk to them? No, you can't. And this went on for like 5 minutes back and forth. And I finally, I started laughing at him. I'm like, you don't get it. Like, I'm not giving you what you want. We could have just said that. I'm like, I did like 6 times. Fine then. Like, he started getting mad and then they hung up on me. I'm like, you motherfucking idiot.
Is the best when someone like says, you could have told me that from the beginning when you already did. That's the best. Like, I just love it's better when it's in text because then you can prove it. It's like, I did look at this text.
Just although, screenshot it.
Have you ever fucked with someone and like,
yes.
Let me finish.
Yeah, going to like fucked with someone.
Like on a Facebook Messenger, and then go into the coding and actually switch around their text and then screenshot it. Have you ever done that?
Well, since Facebook Messenger is cancer, no, not really.
No, I use it all the time. It's great.
It's still cancer.
I love it.
Facebook's cancer.
Enjoy your cancer.
Well, I don't like Facebook. I love Messenger, though. I hate
Facebook. Cancer.
You are cancer.
Your mother is a nice lady.
Your mother is a lymphoma. She took me out to a very nice dinner.
It's a new year. Can we just, like, tone it down on the hate a little bit?
Well, did you see who America elected president? No, this is...
Okay,
we're getting used to the hate because it's going to be fucking nominal levels here.
Listen, I don't really care whatever crap goes down there in nowhere,
don't bring
USA,
it to Canada,
okay?
Man.
But like,
yeah, I know. You guys are already building your wall.
Here in Canada, we're building our wall to keep you guys out. So,
see, I was actually thinking of moving to Canada, like when I'm done with college. Anyways, so maybe
that actually reminds me. We need to figure out when I'm going to go invade Canada for like a weekend.
This is true. And for some reason,
you can stay at Bryan.
But just
dude, we should do a podcast from your place.
So I hit R in World of Warcraft, and that is usually the button to reply to the last person I whispered you. And for some reason, the last person that whispered me, their name is Cancer. As you guys were talking about Facebook being cancer, and I was just like, wow, that's strange.
It's a sign from the universe.
It is a sign from the universe. Wait,
so that science project you're growing in your refrigerator, totally going to cure cancer. So it's going to happen.
Okay, don't diss it. I'm trying. He's trying out different things. Don't worry. We can fix that. Fix this? What? I don't know what I'm on about. Someone stop me before I say something stupid.
Wise
again.
Is having
a
moment.
Podcast
I'm melting. Help.
Podcast from Canada. I like it.
Yeah.
My cat's annoying me. Who
while surrounded by poutine.
Yes.
We will be in swivel chairs and there will be tables like completely surrounding us and we will just spin around and eat poutine on microphone.
A Canada cast, if you will.
Pod Canadast?
a pod Canadast?
Yeah.
Exactly. Me and dude have the right. Me and dude should just go up to Canada, podcast, and then actually, Canada's only like a 6-hour drive from me. So.
Where are you?
I'm up in, like,
Ohio?
I'm right next to Boston, so.
Oh, you're in Jersey, okay.
No.
No, he's not that far, because that would be more hours.
Yeah, I'm literally right next to Boston. I don't like to give specifics, but I'm right next to it.
Give us your address.
Like
Boston is sitting next to him. It's actually the name of his cat.
No, I'm actually going to PAX East, and it's only going to be an hour drive. So,
well, fuck so, you like, too, buddy.
So he can basically be considered Boston.
Yeah, basically. So
just say
it's
Boston.
I'm in Boston.
There we go.
See, this
it's
is gonna
a
be
lot
my
of
first...
fucking money, man.
This is
hey,
gonna be
PAX
my...
East. That could actually be doable for me.
See, this
it
is gonna
be
my first ever PAX, and I've never gone to any kind of convention, so I have no idea what I'm gonna do when I get there. Although,
touch all the butts.
Okay, that no. You don't know. I was never mind.
Record timing of getting kicked out of PAX.
Oh, I could do it in like at least a minute. Literally, all you have to do is just, well, I don't know. There are a lot of weird people at conventions.
I feel like there's a lot of things you could do that would immediately.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's a rather infinite list.
Oh, yeah.
Or what you could do is you could find a guard and touch his butt.
What if he likes it?
Then you go to the locker room and you're never heard from again.
I never heard. Not like you both enjoy something. No, I'm never heard from again.
Pretty much, yes.
He did me so hard, I died.
Well, does that make him a murderer? Does that make him a murderer?
Murdered by penis. I wonder if that's actually a crime that is.
It is. It, well, not a crime, but it's an actual thing that can happen. You can, like, I read a story about someone that, like it was like someone with one of the world's largest cocks, and he actually killed someone. And imagine being that guy. I feel sorry for that guy.
Oh, I saw a documentary at one point that was about several gay males that had gone gay because their dicks were too huge and so women wouldn't sleep with them. And then they're like, well, fine, I give up. I'll just start sticking it in the butt. And, you know, this ain't bad. So, okay.
Hey, you can stick it in, you can stick it in butts with girls as well, okay?
I mean, you can, but, you know, not many girls, well, not as many as the world would like to think.
Well, guys do it wrong.
No, I'm saying this backwards. Not many girls will publicly admit or be willing to try that, but there are a lot more girls into that than the public thinks there are.
Can I get into an awkward situation and ask, would anyone be willing to try that here?
So, dudes
only willing to do it if there's money involved. Okay.
Your question ignores the who here has already done that, because I'm pretty sure I can answer that question in every capacity with a yes, because I am a filthy motherfucker.
Yep.
See,
Daniel's just like, yeah.
Yeah.
This is known.
First-hand experience.
Not first-hand experience, first fist experience.
I'm glad someone picked up on that.
I'm innocent.
So,
to go with that, I'm currently watching a cat eat a mouse.
Vore.
So, different. It's very X-rated.
Okay.
It's very X-rated.
When you go up or down the stairs, does your whole screen shake, Bryan?
Yeah, a little bit. If we're talking about WoW with vanilla, yes.
Yes.
Okay. So is this like a YouTube video or something that you found? Or is this like a deep, dark internet cat and mouse video?
It's actually a still image. Watching was the incorrect term.
Well, it could have been.
Looking at it.
Yeah,
looking watching at the it, image. I guess it has been.
Well, okay. So, speaking of Vore, have you ever heard
of
us?
Whoa. This. Our slippery slope has become a cliff.
So, no. Let me continue. Okay.
All right. I'm fucking down. Let's do this. Down the dark hole we go.
Down. Okay, so have any of you heard of a streaming service called Picarto? I think that's how you.
Picarto, yes, I have it.
You have. Okay, so I've been looking at it to see if there are any good artists. I found like three that aren't My Little Pony. Well, actually, one of them is My Little Pony. But
of course,
My Little Pony, a furry, like furry artist, or like just weird. But one of them, I saw a Source filmmaker preview image. It was just like, it was a spy, I think. So I joined the stream, and it's like, okay, it ended up being like a My Little Pony character. It's like, okay, whatever, I'll just go with it. And then I'm like just watching him animate something regular, and then I type in, like, and then I start seeing people doing role-playing. I'm like, okay, this is weird. So I type in, like, hey, actually, what is this animation for? He's like, oh, it's a Vore animation I'm working on. And I'm like, what have I stumbled into? If I wasn't... What?
Womp, 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 womp.
I also ended up, like, I don't know how. I keep getting in the furry and the My Little Pony community. And I don't
we know you like it.
I wish I did. That's a thing. Because then I could at least say, hey, yeah, I'm really into it. But no, I'm not.
We'll just keep exposing you to it, and it'll be like doing hard drugs or something where you just slowly get used to it and just eat more.
This is the gateway drug for me. Picardo is the gateway.
I just flipped penis chips into my face.
Way to go.
I wonder what that noise was. It sounded like
that was like
yip. Like a puppy yip.
I
want someone to extract.
I have done that before on the podcast. I know I have.
I want someone to extract the audio for that, and then like for the intro, someone just play that at the end. So
I will do that.
Over and over again.
Just loop it over.
I was gonna say chip tune it to like a Lebanon polka or something.
You chip tune it to what's his name's song? What's that guy's name?
Exactly. I know what you. Yeah, that guy.
No, the guy that does the parody songs. What's his name?
Weird Al.
Yeah, Weird Al's poker face.
Oh God.
That'd be perfect. Can't read my. No, you can't read my polka face. She's got no love. Yeah.
Perfect. I love it.
See, but it'd be like all those yips. So yip yip yip
yip yip. Okay, speaking of polka, there's a metal band out there called, I'm going to butcher it if I can't read it, but they did Levin's polka in metal format. It's a Korpiklani is a metal.
Wait, Korpiklani, I know of them. They made a song like... A song like Beer, I think it was.
Yes.
Ah, they're great. Well, at least from that song I heard, they're great. I weirdly know everything that everyone else knows here, but I don't talk much here. This is the weird thing.
You don't talk much here?
You just need to fix that.
Well, no. In the call I do, I dropped something, but I don't talk much in the chat. That's my, yeah.
I barely say anything.
Me while I have a meltdown. I need to drink something.
I barely say anything in our talk chatty as well.
You used to. What happened?
No, not really.
Yeah, you used to. You used to be the voice.
I always used to be a lurker.
Yeah, I would say Bryan is Captain Lurker. I'm good with that. That's a
pretty much
fitting.
Captain. I figured, well, you know, I make up for it by, you know, like doing the podcast stuff.
Right. Well, I feel like that's like both a good and a bad thing about Discord is in TeamSpeak, you kind of had to be motivated to join TeamSpeak and leave it going. And a lot of people didn't like leaving it going in the background because really we didn't often use it for chat, like text chat purposes. And we're really just in it for voice, and not everybody wants to be in voice all the time. So Discord being kind of like the living shout box, and it's meant to be open all the time. And so we can talk and share stuff really easily without having to be in voice. And I think that's really awesome. But at the same time, it also means it kind of inclinates people to not be on voice as much.
And I only like voice.
And yeah, and then, you know, this motherfucker over here. No, we love you, Katie.
We do.
Also, one of the downsides to that, too, is that, I mean, our website has just gotten no love.
Well, I have posted like a lot. A little bit. Nobody replied, so I said, fuck it.
It's because we're mostly just on Discord now.
Well, it's your own fault. We got a forum. Get on it now.
So, speaking of website, good segue there. I still have to fix the podcast page because it's not buffering properly. So if anybody is actually getting their podcast from it and realizing that, you know, we're like 10 plus podcasts out of date on that page, there's some sort of strange buffering problem that I need to solve on it. That I just want to make sure that I'm not killing your and our bandwidth doing it. I've also bothered... need to bother some Nightwatch stuff about it, because themes, changing the themes and launching the alpha website is a thing that is pretty much near happening. You need to tweak some pages and set up a bank account. IA's very own bank account. And awesome. We'll have that. And then one of the other options I'm looking into is then switching from Engine, but that's something we'll talk about much later down the line. So, but website relaunch, kind of, you know, getting close to that. So hopefully that'll help with that. I'm going to try and consolidate the forums to make it a little more fun and useful rather than huge meandering mazes of walls of text, because we don't need all the, we don't need a lot of it, since Discord kind of fills that niche of just, you know, the what's a good word for it, the just kind of random chat. Conversation chat. Yeah,
shit posting.
Well, I I like forums, but I'm old school. Everyone else seems to like Facebook, Discord.
I like Twitter and Discord. I hate Facebook. I hate it.
Well, social media. Let's just say social media.
Social.
Yeah, it's Discord is more social media inclined. I think the forums have a good purpose in sharing things that you want to like be able to link to. So like game guides and updates and trying to organize events and
furry porn.
Furry porn or
all of it.
Things like I went to PAX East. Here's all the cool pictures I took. I think that's really good stuff to put on the forum, because if you put it on Discord, eventually it's going to get pushed out of the way by the continuing chat. And so that's kind of annoying to have to go seek and find it again.
See, that's why I like forums, so
I'm saying that's what I think the forums are good for, but we have to kind of like make that clear. And I think it's just not very clear for a lot of people on that right now, especially since the forums are kind of a mess right now. It's a little intimidating.
Best part about Discord is that, well, best and worst, because here's the thing. Discord has a little pop-up thing that says, hey, this is happening now. I sent a message, blah, 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 blah. The bad thing about it is that whenever I'm working in Blender, I always, for some reason, whenever Discord message pops up, it says I can't, like, not says, but it doesn't let you, like, click on anything it until the message goes down. So when there's a string of messages, I'm just sitting there for, like, 5 minutes just waiting for the messages all to disappear so I can mute the channel.
So, yeah, I was going to say, I think you have a notification setting, doohickey, that is incorrectly set. Because they default new servers, as well as your own user global settings, that every message in every channel will be a notification.
Well,
the
more useful
way to do that is to make it so that it's only at mentions.
Oh, no, I know that. I know that. I like the notifications because I'm a moderator for those who know it.
I know it.
The Crown Prince Discord. And just to make sure everything's like safe, because most of the other people, other moderators, they all have it on only mentions. And I'm basically the community manager there. So I usually have it on all things, so I know what's going on at all times.
So you're basically being an overbearing parent and stalking all of your children.
Yes.
You little fuck.
Yes. Okay. Yes. I'm very bad at actually using any type of power for, like, the only time I've ever threatened to, like, kick someone.
I'm not actually questioning your way of running things. I'm making a joke for the sake of...
I know, I'm just saying how
being an asshole, man.
I'm explaining
Don't take it
how...
too hard. I didn't mean... Are we still friends?
No. I don't know why I called you baby there, but okay.
You're not supposed to tell anybody that.
Oh, shh. Okay, we've been naked for like over half an hour now, and we started masturbating. I think it's fine to say it now.
It's the no pants club. I mean, literally, it's part of the rules of IA. No pants.
Yeah, it's like Fight Club but reverse.
Except you have to talk about it twice.
I love Fight Club. Okay.
I haven't seen that
great
yet.
Movie.
Or read it.
The book, not the movie.
There's two. There's three things. There's a game. There's a movie. There's a book. I haven't seen or played or saw any of them.
Yeah, we don't talk about the game.
Yeah.
The motion still images for the cutscenes. It's like the GIF image
library.
It's like Windows Movie Maker, and they tried to make a game out of it. It's so yeah. great. I remember when I tried to make animations in Windows Movie Maker. That was horrible.
I remember trying to make YouTube poop in Movie Maker. Great for making things super, super fucking loud, but not good for anything else.
Ugh.
It's good for making memes.
That clipping.
Yeah.
What?
That clipping, though.
So, yes. Moving on from Windows Movie Maker, furry porn, nakedness, and what else did we mention?
I don't know, furry porn?
We already mentioned that. We seem
you know
to
what?
Mention-
I know. We alluded to it earlier. Let's talk video game awards.
Okay.
All right.
And just, you know, good releases that we've had throughout the 2016 year.
Good releases? Good releases. Are we still talking about masturbation?
We can, but we're talking about the game awards. So
well, they're just as masturbatory, so yeah. Hey-o!
Oh,
well,
there you go.
But, yeah, I haven't played any games from 2016, so, yeah.
Uh-huh.
I don't get new games. I wait, like, at least 3 years. The only game I've considered getting that just came out were, like, the only two were the new Doom game, because I love Doom, and, what's it called?
Dave actually
The Last Guardian.
Game.
What?
My friend Dave actually bought the new Doom. It's like, wow, I have it, he has it, who else has it? We can all play together. Wait a minute. Can you multiplayer on that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, we can all play.
PC or console? Because apparently that matters.
PC.
Oh, yes! Yes!
See, I'm going to be the weird one out here, but I only like to game on console. I hate
it. Get the fuck out.
See, the reasoning is, I work.
WizemanTheWicked was kicked from the server.
I work all the time on my computer. When I want to play, I want to get up, get away from the computer. I want to get in a place where it's like, okay, it's different from the workplace. That's why I hate playing on computer.
So what you do is, you get a good computer, and you stream it to your TV.
There you go.
Well, that would require a smart TV, and also it's just the same. I'm using a controller.
Mm. But you get the power of a PC.
I have a terrible PC anyways. Mine's from like 2009. So.
Potato 2.1, huh?
Yeah, exactly.
No, same potato here.
Mom, potato 3.1.
One potato, two potato, three potato, four, five potato, six potato, seven potato more.
And now your computer smells like potatoes.
It's not
French fried computer.
Feel like ordering pizza, and it's all Dude Run's fault. I think was it you who ordered pizza?
I ordered pizza beforehand.
We started the conversation with the game awards.
Yep. Yeah. Somehow we're talking about pizza.
We're not talking about BAFTA, by the way. We're talking about the Game Awards 2016. Separate thing entirely.
But gaming and pizza go together.
That
they kind of do. I mean, I'm doing
along
it
right
with now.
Mountain Dew and Doritos.
But I'm eating pizza while playing video games.
Here's the question: what's the best topping for pizza?
I like Hawaiian.
Oh, pineapple for sure.
Cheese.
Yeah, definitely Hawaiian.
Mushroom.
Cheese.
Well, cheese is a thing that goes on pizza anyway. You can't have pizza without
tomato
cheese.
Sauce.
Hold on. Wise said mushrooms. Wise man the Wicked was kicked from the server.
Mushrooms
Bryan
are
said
great.
Pineapple. Do that's like a kick-worthy thing? Fuck that. No.
What is
mushrooms
wrong with you,
are amazing.
No.
That in the vegetarian.
Pineapples are good.
Mushroom and vegetarian.
Get out.
Oh, I love it.
Oh my god. No.
I'm not vegetarian. I just really like vegetarian pizza.
There are some good veggie pizzas, but no mushrooms. Ew.
In his defense, I actually love mushrooms on pizza as well.
God damn it. All of you are kicked from the server.
You're kicked from the server.
It's still Shro left. Shro is the only one left in the server.
Shro does not eat fungus. Fungi.
Welcome to the IA podcast known as Shro Fumes About Mushrooms.
Shro doesn't like to eat fun guys. What?
Yeah, it's true.
Otherwise, I would have been eaten a long time ago.
Oh, baby.
Oh, yes. Oh,
I like I'm burning.
I like to eat fun guys mushrooms.
I can't get used to how in this game, if you walk near a fire, it burns.
Well, yeah, that's what fire does, you know?
It usually does other that. Games.
What the fuck?
Yeah. Games usually do that. If you're on fire, you're going to get fired.
In Guild Wars 2, you can stand in a fire and you don't burn.
But you got like a condition that causes burning.
Guild Wars 2 is not the most realistically representative game of real life, okay? WoW is real life.
They have levitating airships and stargates, and they're swinging swords at each other. Let's be honest here.
And yet they can't communicate long distance.
Yeah, and they have
mail from owls.
Well, I mean, you do got flying animals and weird contraptions in WoW.
You have a Pokemon called Dewgon in Guild Wars.
What? No.
What? Pokemon?
What are you talking about?
How do we get from the Game Awards to Pokemon?
Well, didn't they win like a Game Award? Because wasn't there a new Pokemon game that just came out last year?
Let me check.
Sun and Moon, yes.
Yeah, Pokemon Go won Best Mobile Game.
Why am I always lost? Year.
Yeah.
Which is funny considering game.
Yeah. Best Metal Game?
No, I see Best Family Game for Pokemon Go. Also got Best Mobile Handheld Game, too.
Best Metal Game. Is that what you just said?
Mobile.
Metal Game. Let's see.
Metal Game.
Mobile. I would imagine Doom would win that. First off,
Was hoping Doom would win the middle game of the year award.
Oh my God.
Okay,
how did Pokemon get it?
Okay, it's saying best narrative game, Uncharted 4. That is the worst. That's not a good choice for best narrative.
How do you know? Hey, you played it.
You know what didn't win there, and that's okay. Inside, because fuck Inside.
I haven't played it.
You shouldn't.
Never heard of it. Never heard of
good.
It.
Good.
Best action game. Doom.
It's saying the best music and sound design is Doom, which
I kind of agree. Like
sound design is really important for Doom, and I think they've done a good job with it. Civ 6 got best strategy game.
Inside
which
won two games, apparently.
Inside won two games, you say? Did they win?
They won. They won Resident Evil 4, and they won Overwatch.
Won free Overwatch.
It's like they won fuckers. Lives, but as games. I don't know what I'm on about.
Inside one best art direction and
I think I was trying to make it like game. It's a medieval tournament like winning thing, but I just kind of didn't explain that.
I'm actually still wondering about like I kind of agree with the controversy surrounding best esports game being Overwatch. I almost feel like the result there is that it's perhaps one of the only esports games to actually release in 2016, and therefore it just kind of, you know, contest.
Battleborn.
As much as esports has made great strides in the last couple of years, you know, it's like to have its own award like that when not a lot of games are really, you know, geared towards esports. It seems kind of stupid. Like, I don't feel the time is right to have an award like that.
Right. It's a little presumptuous, I would say.
You know, and this is in no way knocking Overwatch because I mean, Overwatch is a fucking fantastic game.
It is a fantastic game. Though I will actually knock it a little bit due to the fact that Blizzard has always made their games to, quote, be more fun to play than some of the more hardcore stuff. As a result, many people, especially from more quote unquote hardcore games from the esports realm, have noted that Overwatch kind of is a little forgiving in some of its skill categories, if you will, in like sniping especially. You don't need to be actually like pinpoint on for headshots. The game kind of forgives you a little bit here and there. And so that calls into question, like, what are you actually measuring in a quote unquote esports competition of a game of Overwatch? Are you going after like the player's ability to synergize as a team, to pick good classes, to choose good routes, or are we really talking about like Twitch reflexes to get something going?
I hear a puppy.
Yes, this is my dog, which we've apparently decided we're going to, instead of actually caring about the dog needing to go outside and just putting the dog outside or helping her with it, whatever we need, my family has this wonderful idea where instead we rile the dog up, go, hey, you clearly need to do this thing, and instead of doing it for you, we're just going to help encourage you to spaz out and try to make do it for you.
Everyone now knows Schrodinger's name.
So,
yeah,
with that being said, I guess
you
I
say
will
your name in podcast there, Shro.
Huh?
You said your name.
Oh, yeah, I did. Real I name. Guess we'll have to fix that.
Yeah, I guess I will.
There's editing. Yeah,
maybe.
There's more editing. Just put. Ooh,
Jinx. Hey, hold on. Wait, everyone, be real quiet for a second. Okay, dude, now replace my real name with the sound of my dog barking.
Oh, no. Dude.
I already decided on a sound to replace that with. You're fine.
No, right. No, yeah, you should do the little thing he did, the thing he did.
Yeah, right. That's what I'm going
to
do.
I'll be right back. Name? I have to go put my dog out. You guys carry on with your stuff.
I'm going to order pizza because I am starving, and yet I can't really just go and make food if I'm here.
You know what you could also do instead of buying pizza?
Get you to order it for me and send it my way.
I was going to say buy Overwatch.
Overwatch is more expensive than pizza.
Here's what you could do, though,
pizza
Bryan.
For a couple of, you know,
Bryan,
for a couple of weeks.
Here's what you could do. You could buy Overwatch
pizza
for Katie.
For a couple months.
And then that's it.
Yeah, there you go, dude. Bryan.
Or, alternatively, what we could do is we can buy $60 worth of pizza for all of us.
Yes.
Yeah,
I like
agree.
That idea.
It's on your tab.
You're talking to a person with that's actually in debt right now. So.
How much are you in debt? I'm in debt $15,000.
You win. Now, to continue the game awards, I hate this thing. Most anticipated game. Legend of Zelda, Breath of the Wild. Now, the reason I hate this is because it's just which popular game that hasn't come out yet has the most budget put into it.
Or the most hype surrounding it.
Yeah, but no.
Not even
most hype would make sense.
Budget, most hype would make the most hype, which is, in my opinion, kind of like, who cares about hype? You know, you're here to award something to give credit where credit is due, you know? And Zelda game, of course Zelda game's gonna have a lot of hype. It's a Zelda game, you know? It could have it could be like a mobile Zelda game or something, and it probably still would get like most anticipated game of the next year.
It's just masturbatory to me. Just like, hey, we're gonna let Nintendo win this because they're a popular gaming thing, right? So, it's just annoying to me.
I totally agree.
I also, this one just doesn't make sense to me. Trending gamer, Boogie2988. I said three eights there. Ignore that. I just don't get
two.
That. Like, he was, like, popular. Like, he's still popular, but he was popular. Like, he got most of his popularity a while ago. Why is he now trending? I don't get that.
I don't know, but good on him for getting an award for it, I guess.
Yeah, I'm not like saying like he shouldn't have. I'm just doesn't make sense.
Totally.
So has anyone actually heard of this game Inside? Because
Shro
said,
has.
Yeah, Shro has, and he said that he hates it. And without him just saying it's awful, I want to know why.
I have not played it either, and apparently Shro has, and that's it. But I don't know.
Another one is best VR game, and this is the one of VR games I haven't heard of, Res Infinite. Has anyone heard of that one?
Nor have I. I have not.
I have not heard of this game, no.
I'm gonna look this up. What is it? But best, like, isn't really a game, but the best thing I've seen for VR is Tilt Brush, because, like, if anyone wants to see what Tilt Brush is like, look up Draw with Jazza Tilt Brush, like painting the Iron Giant. That it just shows how great, like, VR can be used for art and stuff like that.
Is this that program that you can, like, is it a Vive program that you can just, like, paint with in a 3D space? Oh my god, I want that.
What was I looking up earlier?
I don't know.
Was it?
Something about
Res Infinite. Res Infinite.
Res Infinite, right.
But yeah, it's, the cool thing about it is that, like, as a 3D artist, it's a very cool thing to make a 3D model, but it's hard to, like, you know, say how, like, what it's like to, I'm trying to explain how you'd make it and how it works and stuff like that. And with this, it's not the same at all, but it kind of, like, shows you, like, it kind of gets you into how 3D art kind of works digitally, because it just puts you in the program in first person rather than using, like, an editor. It kind of shows the layman how to do it, you know what I mean? Like, how someone would theoretically. Obviously, you would never use it for an animation, but also, I just looked up Res Infinite, and it is a third-person game. That makes no sense to me. The best VR game is third-person.
Why?
I don't know. The entire point of VR is to be in, like, you can't have a 3D, like, you can have a third-person VR game, but that should not win the best VR game.
Yeah. Unless, like, there's, like, a first-person mode specifically for VR.
Like, all the screenshots I'm looking at, they're all third-person. You play as, like, basically a female version of the Silver Surfer.
But
without a surfboard. And it's, it just doesn't make sense. Why would you play, like, why would that win?
This is, I don't, why I get it.
This is why I hate the BAFTA awards. They do not know how to properly award things.
Well, it's not, like, BAFTA, it's a different thing.
Oh, it's not?
Yeah, it's completely separate.
Oh, I just clicked the link. I thought we were talking about, what is it then? I don't know,
it's a separate thing entirely. It's just called the Game Awards.
Ghosted?
I don't know.
Hold on, who actually is this run by? The Game Awards official website. Let's go down the rabbit hole. Let's figure out
this shit, and then,
yes, I'm doing so right now. Okay, no, even the website won't tell me. Let's see. I'm pretty sure it's BAFTA. I don't know.
BAFTA
runs the Game Awards. Let's see. It's just Game Awards.
Yep.
Huh. I don't trust. They were built from the ground up on, like, gaming stuff, and they still fail. So, yeah. That's my opinion on the Game Awards. Most of them are terrible.
I honestly,
well, yeah, we lost faith in the Game Awards this year. Also, hi, I'm back.
I had lost, like, all credibility for me has been lost with Gaming Awards for years now. They don't mean anything to me, you know? It's just like,
right?
It's basically other people's opinion.
Yeah.
And, you know, sometimes it might not match up with my own, so.
I kind of look at it as
a, it means very little.
Let's see how disconnected we are with our industry and fan base, and or how different my opinions are than people that think their opinions are that matter.
Exactly. I mean, it's you could see it as it's kind of a highlight of, you know, of games that have come out throughout the years, but it's not really, I don't see it as a definitive award or list or anything meaningful, really.
Yeah.
Especially since there's so many of them, you know?
Right. Nowadays, for sure.
It's not like, you know, it's not like the Oscars or, you know, the Grammys or something. It's just like every little website, I mean, and
there's
everything
a lot of stuff in those environments too.
That's true, but I mean, not to the I feel like not to the extent of gaming, where it's just kind of everywhere. But you know, I mean, to the point where like video games actually put like Game of the Year as mentioned by GameSpot, you know, and it's like, who the fuck cares?
Yeah, people with narrow minds who can't think for themselves.
Well, listen, dude, when we yeah, you're right. You're right.
Yeah. I was going to say, my big letdown, and I won't actually rant this time, was, in fact, the Inside, because I watched someone else play it, but, you know, it's a very linear narrative game, so you've seen it once, you've seen it forever. The game is absolutely beautiful. It's not actually a big question that it won the Art Direction Award, but the reason I hate it so much is the game, as you play it, builds itself up. It exposes you to so many interesting mechanics, interesting, how shall you say, lore options, really. There's like a lot of it that like you want to learn about, you want to go and explore it, and there's just such an interesting universe that they beautifully crafted around it in both mechanics of some of the puzzles as well as just the environment that you go through, and then it like doesn't explore any of it. The game just suddenly ends after going through an extraordinarily, I can't describe it any better than an M. Night Shyamalan plot twist. It's very left field and kind of anticlimactic, and then it's just done. And you're like, that's it? And that's why I hate it so much, is it's not a, oh, this game gave me so much to think about. No, it's like really pensive, really, you know, challenging things. It's just like, oh, this game had a lot to offer and failed to deliver.
That's basically Arkham Knight. Arkham Knight was built so, like, I hated how Arkham Knight turned out because it had such good potential and then they ruined it all. Arkham Knight was probably like the worst Arkham game made so far, if I'm being honest.
Where'd everyone go?
Fair enough.
Yeah, that's what I hear. I mean, well, we've had a couple of those throughout the year. We had No Man's Sky. Apparently that one was a big letdown.
Oh, yeah.
So, you know, it's...
I actually feel kind of bad still, and I've said that a few times in the podcast, that I feel kind of bad about how crazy that the reception and fallout from that was.
Yeah, it's just... It was just... A bad, like, it was bad marketing mainly because everyone thought it was gonna be something it's not.
Yeah, pretty much. They got this,
although
great hype for a game that really didn't exist.
Yeah, but the thing was, it's a reverse problem with the Wii U. The Wii U got no hype and it ended up being something that, like, you know what I mean? The Wii U got no hype and sold terribly. But everyone that got it liked it. And then it was the reverse for No Man's Sky.
Yeah. There is actually something that came out recently. I'm looking up the name. I think this is it.
I have to get going. I'll leave now.
Okay.
Thank you for having
Goodbye.
Me.
Goodbye. Get out.
I'm getting out.
Bye.
No one loves me.
Well, thank you for joining us. It was definitely fun having you on, and let's do this again soon.
Hopefully.
For sure.
Yeah.
Astroneer. Astroneer is a little indie game that came out that is basically No Man's Sky, what people thought it was going to be. you can build bases, you collect resources to build your bases, as well as build up your spaceships. You can travel in and out of things, and you can play with your friends and do all of the stuff that you basically wanted to do in No Man's Sky. Hell, it even kind of looks like No Man's Sky with that like pastel color palette thing going on. And it's a little bit procedurally generated. Mm-hmm. So, and it's gotten incredibly positive reviews, but it's an early access game. So that's its little hitch at the moment on that. Mm. So if you were somebody that wanted No Man's Sky to be super awesome and weren't happy with it, check out Astroneer. I think it's like $20 right now in Steam.
Are we still podcasting?
We are still podcasting, though. I think we are going to wrap it up a little bit. We've been going for about a little over an hour for part one here.
Hour and 20 minutes.
We'll come back with part two and combine everything together.
But before, I just want to make an announcement.
Sure.
If you're all free right now, I say let's play some Overwatch right now.
I'd be down.
I am down.
Katie, check your email.
I would say, wait, really? You do have it.
Yes, you do have it.
When I went to the other room to make tea, check on my cat, order pizza. And I didn't order pizza yet because I had other things to do. All that time,
you guys discussed something?
I didn't even know this. I had played the beta, the open beta. So wouldn't I just have to update? I don't know how that would work.
You'd have to update the client, yeah. But
You'd have to update the client.
So you'd have to download less, but you still have to download it.
Yeah, and everything you had in the open beta does not carry over, so...
Mm-hmm.
Any of the skins you may have gotten or credits.
That's a thing.
Did you just clap?
I did. I got excited. Don't get me too excited or I'll piddle on the floor.
You'll puddle on the floor?
Yeah.
Another thing I do want to talk, I'll do it in the next episode, really, about some more stuff with... Night in the Woods, other games that we're expecting out, other changes with IA, things that are going on, and the fact that when we get ready to launch the new website and a few other things, there will be contests, including free games and like decent ones, like probably a copy of Overwatch and copies of Night in the Woods, because God, yes, I'm going to pump that up. Various other things here. I meant to buy a bunch of shit on the Steam sale, and I think it's over, and now it's going to cost a lot. So we'll see what happens. And yeah, so
get stuff and things.
Yeah, get stoked.
Get stoked, people. It's going to be good.
Use the lemons to buy more games.
Give me lemons so I can throw them at game developers to get me games.
What does a snowflake and a zucchini mean?
That's an eggplant, you asshole.
Whatever, it's a purple dildo-looking thing.
A snowflake and a zucchini walk into a bar.
It's an eggplant!
Whatever.
Clearly someone using an eggplant has had some practice with the zucchini already, because there's a greater circumference that you have to encompass between the sphincter.
Because Explorer is saying it's a penis. And he's saying snowflake penis. I don't know what it means.
Eggplants aren't flaky, Bryan. What are you doing to your eggplants? It is not consensual or okay.
That is a snowflake.
What is it? It's too tiny, dude. Run. What is that? That's not a dildo. That's a piece of chalk. It's so tiny.
It's a poorly rendered dildo because Discord tried to do Telegram stickers and failed horribly.
It doesn't look like a dildo.
So we should probably wrap this up before we actually extend it to the 11 o'clock podcast. This just ends up being like a 10-hour thing.
Podcast.
Just when you
surprise, the podcast was actually a 24-hour charity stream.
And we never posted the link. No one told me.
Why am I sneezing suddenly?
Because you're catching my cold, sorry.
Dude, no! You know I have a low immune system.
I'm sorry.
Don't kill Katie.
I'm trying not to. I didn't mean to. Katie,
start updating your client.
Explore is saying someone's using a veggie as a dildo.
Katie, oh, the eggplant attention. Emoji is used
I'm
as a dildo.
I'm actually dying right now, so Katie, I'll pay attention after Katie, I'm alive, Katie. Okay?
No. Start updating your client.
No, I'm dying.
Start updating Overwatch when you die.
No.
Overwatch. And that. Yeah, that too.
Okay, I'm out of compact now. Okay.
You know, I also forgot to mention that I've gotten Heroes of the Storm.
Oh, yeah. That's
or rather, re-gotten it, because technically I got it well over a year ago as my first Blizzard game, and I installed it, and then I never once launched it, and then my computer exploded.
And then recently...
Yeah, it exploded for a whole year.
It's been exploding this whole time, yeah.
Yes, it's slow motion explosion. There's actually a time dilation
explosion.
Michael Bay
was in charge of the repair.
Oh my. I can't get... Why can't I get up there?
I don't know. Probably because I haven't stopped the recording.
Listeners, I think it's a good time to stop. So,
thank you again.
Push that button.
Thank you again, everyone, for being on here. We'll see you next time.
Yeah,
it's
bye.
Hard to do
in a few hours. Hello and welcome to part two of 2017's inaugural IA podcast.
Yay.
Once again, it is an open mic session, this time with a few different people. Everybody that is not Bryan, Dubrun, or myself, and Katie, because you were here the last time, introduce yourselves. All at once.
I'm Squaz.
There we go.
Oh my. Wow. He just appeared out of nowhere.
That's no, I've always been
here. He's been here the whole time.
Oh, okay. I just haven't heard him say anything.
Because I've been just listening everything.
Okay.
Now I'm interrupting.
You're
crazy. I'm dancing on a table.
I slap you with the other glove. Explorer, you gonna say hi, or are you just gonna be a creeper?
Hi, and I'm...
There you go.
There we go.
Shit, he's a creeper! Boom! No Minecraft, okay.
No Minecraft.
Minecraft.
Excuse me, Minecraft is an amazing game.
It is, yeah, it is an amazing game. We didn't question that.
Apparently my friend JP has recently rediscovered Minecraft, and he's like, I don't know what happened to my life yesterday. Step one, play Minecraft. Step two, question mark. Step three, no profit, just more Minecraft. Like, you're doing it right? Wrong? I don't know.
You're doing it in a way.
It's all Minecraft all the time.
This path is acceptable. Anyways, we are going to continue on with our craziness and our open mic discussion. We got a few other things we talked about. We left off last time with the video game awards and how they're kind of a joke, but they're still kind of amusing. So I guess we pay attention to them a little bit.
Wait, are we talking about the Steam Awards?
No, the actual game awards that happened earlier with games like Overwatch getting Game of the Year and Doom getting Best Sound
Best
Design
Action Game.
And yeah, and Best Action Game, and games that shall not be named being nominated for several things and actually winning Best Art Design. Fuck that shit. Fuck it. No, actually fucking it would be doing it a favor. Just kill it. Kill it with a shotgun behind the shed. Put it down. Town.
That guy's name was Father Mucker.
Those game awards usually get the game of the year right on spot. But then you have all the middle categories come best sound, best development, best artistic style. That's just a joke. I mean, that just comes down to personal preference of the guy picking the category.
Yeah. We were actually discussing last in the previous portion how the esports category seems a little ahead of its time, and so thus right now seems kind of awkward for things like, you know, best esports game was Overwatch, but really, were there any true contenders to that? And does Overwatch even really count as an esports game? Because it's a very different feel, despite just being a multiplayer FPS. Did it win that category because it's just simply the multiplayer FPS of the year?
Honestly, I think esports should be a sports game and not first-person shooter. That's my personal opinion. It makes no sense that a first-person shooter would win a sports game. There we go. There's my two cents.
Fair enough.
Yeah, I think that esports should be any game that is fair. First of all, fair on both sides, and there are official tournaments done. For example, Dota, it's 5v5. Everybody has the same the same chances. It's pretty much comes down to skill. The same thing for Counter-Strike. That's why Overwatch could fall into that category, because it's what, 6v6?
Mm-hmm.
And it's always 6v6, not like the TF2 matchmaking that it's like 19v20. It's like that makes no sense. It still has to be small teams, but also has to be the key point is it has to be, first of all, two teams, and both teams have to have the same advantage and disadvantages. And obviously, official competitions that you win like billions and billions of dollars. That's my take on it. And also going back to the awards, I just love it how the host completely insulted the gaming community with that Michael Phelps quote. I can't tell you like the exact point because I don't have the video.
I was going to say, I actually didn't watch any of the real broadcast. What happened? I missed that.
Oh, man, the guy said he was explaining for our next presenter, the person that was going to present the, I think it was the player, the esports player of the year.
Or maybe team of the year.
Something like that. And the presenter goes, this person is the most decorated Olympian, has X amount of medals, and is participating in the last Olympics. You guys probably don't know him, but nonetheless, here's Michael Phelps.
Wow. Wow.
You guys have probably never heard of him, but nonetheless, here comes Michael Phelps. That's amazing.
That's wow. Terrible.
I laughed out loud when I heard that. And then you have the Warframe bit as well. When she said like, "Oh, we have 80,000 losers." I mean, subscribers.
Wow, that's cringeworthy.
Ouch. Sorry, users. So she makes users and losers, but she said we have 80,000 users.
God damn.
So I found those two blunts like really funny from those Game Awards. I mean, I can't take them seriously after that.
I've never taken any Game Awards seriously.
So who is the host of? Was it a famous person? A host?
No. I don't know who the host is. It's just some random dude.
I don't remember which awards it was. I want to say it was a developer-based awards for games. Like it was honoring devs for different categories. But I remember Double Fine actually hosted it, and they did a great job with that. I might have to actually look that up now. Because I think they've turned it into an annual thing.
The host of the Game Awards was Jeff Keighley.
Really?
He's a video games journalist from Canada and a television presenter.
Is this a guy that was in G4 and he hosted BlizzCon a couple of times?
He was the co-host for the now defunct G4 TV.
Okay, I'm actually really disappointed because he's usually one of the better hosts when it comes to like hosting.
Who hosted it?
Sorry?
Who hosted it?
My name's Jeff Keighley.
Yeah, he's been fine when I've seen him in the past. He has good shows. Like he does. Was it Game Trailers?
Game Trailers. He hosted like BlizzCon a couple of times. Well, yeah.
I've seen him at E3 too. Typically commentates that.
So I'm really surprised that, like, from the sounds of it, it just really doesn't sound like him. That's really weird.
Maybe I had it wrong. He does have a hand in it, though.
Damn.
It's the Game Developer Choice Awards that Double Fine hosted, and Tim Schafer was the guy leading it, because he's the CEO of Double Fine.
Of course.
So... that was the thing. I thought they did good with that. since we were talking about video game awards. But I also love Double Fine, so biased.
You do kind of have a huge boner for Double Fine.
So good! I mean, I have a huge boner for a lot of, you know, Bethesda and a few other indie devs.
Bethesda's popular in this house.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
Another topic of discussion that we kind of hit with our holiday discussions, but this month and the past month are kind of big traveling times. Has anybody done some fun traveling recently that they'd like to share?
Nope.
Nope. Fuck traveling. I don't do anything. Hide in my house.
Well, if you count traveling to suffer at the mall every day for a month and a half, that's what I did.
You watch all the other people traveling and go, fuck all of you.
Yep.
I want you to die. I want you to die. I want you to die slowly. You gave me pretzels the other day. You're okay. And fuck that little kid over there. God damn it, that little asshole. He keeps throwing his cookies all over. Okay, I'm done.
I want cookies now.
One of the last days I worked, because I'm officially done because I was only seasonal. One of the last days I worked, I was cleaning up at the end of shift, of which I did 15,500 steps in one shift, 7-hour shift.
That's a decent amount.
Yes, I hurt everywhere, by the way. I found jelly beans all over the floor. It was great. I was very tempted to eat them, but I didn't know how long they were on the floor.
That moment where you sit there and go, yep, I have no dignity, and I'm okay with it.
Okay, I don't have any dignity. I have a almost 5-year-old, okay? You realize how often I get shit off the floor because he throws it there first. Ah, motherhood. Or parenthood.
Well, I can at least share, because I was kind of trying not to go directly into it, but fine, I'll just be that asshole, and I'll take my own prompt. I got to go to Chicago randomly in the middle of December.
And you survived, I see.
Yes, I did. It was actually a lot of fun.
You weren't shot on the way there? That's no. Excellent.
Well, so I had a few friends in the Guild Wars 2 community that live in Chicago. And so when I told them I was up in the area and tried to meet up successfully with one of them, when I told them where we were meeting our other friend, unrelated, and where we were staying there, it was in the Lakeview neighborhood of Chicago. And his response was, oh, yeah, that's a nice, safe, white neighborhood. I'm like, wow. But it was totally true.
I think of all the places in the world that I could travel right now, Chicago would be the last place. North Korea is above people Chicago.
Get murdered. I mean, I'm from I'm from Cleveland. People get murdered in Cleveland more than we really want to admit, too. So
I'm Canadian. What is a murder?
Murder.
The hell's murder.
It's red rum, but spelled backwards. See what I did there? See what I did there?
Yeah.
Somebody needs to add cricket sounds to that pause.
Yeah, really.
Okay, I've made a note.
I used to have cricket sounds on my desktop just for that, but I don't.
It's actually going to be cricket sounds through the whole podcast.
It's the late night version of the IA podcast.
Yeah, it's the ambient moon noises, crickets.
Oh yes.
And up next,
I don't know why I said moon music noises. That's so boring.
Probably some jazz.
Hey, I like jazz. Though. Some nice swing jazz going.
But no, it was a good time. We went to a brewery. We went to a Korean restaurant that had really good Korean stir fry, and then also giant chicken wings that they called Korean fried chicken wings. I'm pretty sure they were just giant chicken wings. That was super tasty. We went to a market that's kind of like a whole paycheck. I mean, I'm sorry, Whole Foods. And
I see. You just pulled a Jeff Keighley. I see.
Yeah, I know. I did. I totally ripped that one. It's a place called Mariano's. And so again, it's like a market, and it had multiple levels to it, which I know that some of you are probably not impressed by that, but to have a grocery store with multiple levels and escalators and shit, like there was an escalator that you specifically put your cart on so that you could go up the escalator with your cart. I mean, how fucking cool is that?
That's pretty cool.
Have that?
Some of them, but not none of them by me. You have to go to places like Chicago for that shit. But no, the best part was we went there during happy hour because, yes, they actually have a bar there and you can get stuff that's normally like $10 a bottle for $2.50. Anything they had, $2.50 during happy hour. So I had like three beers for less than $10. It was great. Also, stupid things in Chicago and other big cities that I'm not used to. The ATM machine to end all ATM machines. First off, my bank card could get me into a building, like some sort of security pass card, which that was cool. Then the ATM is so crazy beastly that it not only can take and spit out coins and whatnot, but can even read your driver's license, barcode, and fingerprint.
Huh.
For what purpose exactly?
I don't know, but it could do it. Also, the thing you had to pull money out of had this, like, it was this slide-away metal door that I'm pretty sure if you did something to fuck with the machine and stuck your hand in it, it would slam this door on your hand. Like, this is just a trap. I feel like I'm reaching into a bear trap. This is just, what else? We went to several hipstery restaurants because that's what my friends from that we went to go visit are like. Also, a place called Portillo's, where you get, actually, I said that wrong. It's got two L's in it, which I automatically make a Y sound like Spanish, and it's actually called Portillo's, and they do pasta and all beef hot dogs. I don't know how you get that combination, but...
You're making me hungry.
It's Chicago-style hot dogs, and they were damn good.
Damn good, all right.
Which apparently ketchup isn't a thing for, like, they have ketchup, but they will not put ketchup on your hot dog, even if you ask them. They're like, no, there's the fucking ketchup dispenser. You can put it on your hot dog. But they'll put mustard, they'll put, like, cucumbers and tomatoes and chili and nacho cheese and relish and mayo and all sorts of crazy shit on your hot dog, but they will not put ketchup on it, because apparently ketchup is some sort of, like, sin in Chicago. So that was interesting.
A little bit of random trivia. The very, very first hamburger restaurant in the world is in Connecticut. Okay, so the place where the very first hamburger was made was a burger with cheese on white bread. And there, you cannot get ketchup. They will literally, if you ask for ketchup, they will literally shoo you out the door without your burger or the ketchup. Because they're like...
I would laugh harder if they gave you the ketchup but no burger. Here's your stinking ketchup! Throw it at you.
Not putting that on our burger. Yeah.
Am I the only one here, but like, I'm not a fan of ketchup.
No, I'm not a huge fan either. So when I do ketchup, do you put like pepper or salt on your fries?
Yes, I love black pepper on fries.
I know, right? It's great. So a long time ago, mostly because I was eating French fries that were already really shitty and I probably shouldn't have been eating to begin with, but you know, especially cold fries or not fresh fries or just bad fries, you go to put like salt or pepper or whatever on it, and all you really ended up doing was putting like three grains of it on your fries and then pouring the rest of it onto the tray below the fries. And I'm like, well, this is useless. So what I started doing is I took my ketchup and I'd pour all the pepper into the ketchup and then stir it up. So that, like, all right, now I have guaranteed pepper on my fries as long as I dip it in the ketchup. And that's actually the only reason I use ketchup now, is because it's just a peppering mechanism for the French fries.
Or you can make it like the Canadians do, poutine, just put extra pepper in the gravy. There you go.
There you go. Yeah. Well, I was gonna say, like the Canadians make it, where we get rid of the ketchup completely and drench it in like three different cheeses, gravy, some potatoes, and whatever else we felt like putting on top of it that isn't ketchup. Also, I'm still convinced, as I said last time in the other part of the podcast, that if and when, and I'm pretty sure it's just going to be a matter of when, I get to go up to Canada to visit Bryan and friends, that, you know, Katie, Squaz, you got to pay attention here, I'm getting together, that we're totally going to do a podcast, and we're going to do it by sitting in swivel chair bar stool things with tables completely surrounding us of every poutine we could find in Toronto.
Toronto doesn't have the good poutine. You gotta go to Quebec and have the actual Montreal.
I am not going to fucking Quebec.
You should.
You should. I had it a couple months ago.
Can I ride the train there, Bryan, from Toronto?
Yes.
Yes, you actually can.
How much does that cost?
$49.99
It depends.
$49.99 round trip. I've done it.
Did you say 29?
Well, for you Americans, that's what it'll come up to, but yeah.
Okay. No, that's fair.
Fuck me, I died.
That's necrophilia.
Yeah.
Bryan's like just jumping around, like an Easter bunny, and I'm dead.
Don't you know that jumping in an MMO is literally the way to communicate any possibility to somebody?
Pretty much. Okay, so
it's how you say hello. It's how you say bye. It's how you say.
It's also how you move.
She asked me where this thing was, so I'm like, here. It's on top here, and then I'm jumping up and down and up and down, and she wasn't coming up there. So
you could have said something.
He was. He was jumping up and down. That is saying something.
Yeah, he did. He typed it.
And I typed it in. I'm like, it's on top of here, and then I was jumping up.
Well, I was busy dying.
Okay, you spent like 2 whole minutes running around until you finally died.
Well, I was trying to get away from him. I was trying to get far enough so I could use my bow.
Well, I'm assuming turning around won't do it. Going on circles.
Okay, now I see a dead corpse that's just kind of walking along.
I do too! What the fuck? How is Destroy walking?
That is hilarious.
How?
In any case.
How?
One last thing about Chicago, since we talked about trains. I really, really like awesome public transit where it was built and meant to be. And because the Chicago Transit Authority, those trains, they're super fucking fast and it's so fucking cool. And I kind of geeked out a little. And by a little, I mean a lot. I actually bought a day pass for the purpose of being able to just ride the train.
I'm on a train.
So, Bryan, when I do visit Toronto and we go into the city, we're riding the metro and I may intentionally miss a stop or two so that I can ride it more. That was our stop. No, we're getting poutine here, but we were supposed to get poutine here. We're getting poutine at literally every stop and then we're getting back on the train going to the next one.
I remember going to Montreal when I was in eighth grade, so that would have been
That was like 300 years ago, wasn't it?
Yes, I was 14. So yeah, the 14th we went for our eighth grade class trip. So after we graduated eighth grade, we went to Montreal and Quebec. And I can remember when we were in Montreal, we literally had to take a ride on the subway because no one had ever been on a subway before, and they were excited.
That's amazing.
Really?
Yes, I had too because I used to go to New York City all the time. So I had an aunt who lived by. So I'd been on subways numerous times. And we literally bought a ticket for the subway just to go on the subway. And I'm like, really?
Awesome. I consider this legit. I feel weird being excited about the Chicago train system because it's actually not my first time on any such thing. Cleveland does actually have a similar system. We call it the Rapid, but it does not, it's not nearly as extensive of a network. It's just like a few hotspot areas. And on top of that, it's street level, so it crosses the road a few times, and so it has to stop for traffic every now and then. And it's just slower. Like, it's not nearly as much fun. I think it tops out at like 40 miles an hour and is usually doing even less. The Chicago trains are like, okay, we're leaving the station. 3 seconds later, we are doing 60 and passing the highway. And that was just kind of fun. when the train accelerates enough to put you on your ass if you're not holding something, it's a good time.
We have a monorail here. It's fun.
The monorails are cool.
Yes, I take my son on them a lot just because it's a monorail. But the shitty thing is it, you know, the monorail system in Vegas, the regular monorail goes from SLS all the way down to MGM. So and it only makes 5 stops. Then you have to get off that monorail, cross the street to get on the other ones to go back up. And then there's 3 separate ones. So what's really fucking annoying is that you, if you start up north by, like, say, you know, you guys seen the Big Tower one, right? The Big Tower Casino, the Stratosphere, the one that looks like the little mini Space Needle.
I mean, there's only like 10 of them.
Okay. Well, it's the one that looks like the Space Needle. That's the Stratosphere. Anyway.
The one that looks like the thing. Anyways, yeah, go ahead.
Well, it is the only one that looks like the freaking Space Needle.
It is true. Okay? Yes, it is.
Okay. So the monorail goes from there, but across the street from it, one of the casinos across the street. Then it comes down to MGM, which is the first one on that side of the road. And you literally have to cross the street and go on 3 separate monorails to go up 5 extra casinos on the other side. So if you go casino hopping, it's really annoying.
Right.
Annoying. So
yeah, at that point, I might just walk.
But can confirm.
It is. We have buses. Our buses are double deckers, which are pretty cool. I don't
That's
know
true. I don't think I've ever been on a. Wait, no, I take that back. I think I've been on one double decker bus.
I've not been on one. I just know they exist. We also have the hyper extendable ones. You know, the ones that got like the rubber extended stuff in the middle.
Yeah, they've got the gasket in the middle of them, and it feels like it's gonna like fall apart like anytime it turns.
Yes.
I would never want to drive one of those things.
I feel like those routes are very limited with those, like,
oh, I'm sure. Speaking of the monorail, though, one of the things I find the coolest thing about the monorail is that it, unlike a normal train that has just the big ass metal wheels and everything, the monorails, at least the ones I know of, are all actually like giant rubber tires.
I can't skin them.
And it's just a weird thought to me that the train has giant rubber tires when you look at it.
Oh, yeah. You have to look at the underside of at least a Disney monorail. It's kind of weird to see.
This is how actual, Disney does it. There might be other ways to do it. I honestly don't know. I'm not a monorail engineer.
I just like saying monorail.
It is kind of fun to say.
Monorail.
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 So what happens when we put 2 of them on the rail? Does it become a bi-rail? Is it unsure about its sexuality?
Becomes a dual lane monorail.
Dual lane monorail.
Would it just be a train?
Maybe it's that'd be simple.
Pan rail.
Pan rail.
Bryan, keep up.
Oh, what else do we got going on? That? Oh, I found a soda shop in Cleveland. That was pretty cool. We did. Me and a few buddies. We went to Cleveland's Christmas tree lighting ceremony a few weeks ago. And we randomly just discovered that we have a, like, soda parlor shop. And I got some crazy energy drink that's, like, called Dragon Tails, and it was really super delicious.
I have never been to a soda shop. Could you describe the atmosphere to me?
Eclectic. And yeah, usually they have very 50s decor. In fact, this place even sold very nerdy, eclectic things that kind of dated from the 50s, but somewhere they also had things like Pokemon and Rick and Morty and My Little Pony. Yeah, there was totally a giant stuffed Luna, and I did think about it because I'm like, okay, I'm not much of a brony, but Luna is best pony. But no.
So on the other side of travel, my in-laws were here, and the last day they were here, my father-in-law literally sliced his goddamn hand open on their heater in the van.
Nice. In the van.
Yeah. And then
wait, on the what in the van?
Heater. They live in the van.
It's not working.
A propane heater.
It's a
camper, but it's in a van. Okay.
Got it. No. I get what you're saying. I know what you're talking about. I was confused because I was thinking like the normal air vents on a car. I'm like, those are plastic. How do you cut your hand open on them?
No, it was a propane heater. And the reason he was messing with it was it was randomly turning on by itself even when the van was unattended.
Why? That's not okay.
Yes, hence why he was trying to fix it. And he sliced his hand open, and then he proceeded to spend 6 hours in the ER because he went to UMC and he should know better. And that was for Explore. He probably understands that. And yeah, so they spent 6 hours and he needs surgery on his hand.
Jesus Christ. Oh my God, seriously?
So
what the hell did he do?
Sliced it open, but now he has to.
Yeah, but what, like, did he, like, just open palm punch the fucking thing? Like, Jesus Christ.
I have no clue. All we know is we were eating at a John's Incredible Beats Company, and we get a phone call from his mother going, yes, so we're at the ER. Like, what? We never saw them after that. But yeah, that was a fantastic day.
Too funny. Well, I hope he's okay. I yesterday I discovered that I had cut myself at work because I have a new job now, and I was trying to describe it to Squaz as I have to try to explain how units work for lights and how matching lights up works to everyone over the age of 30 because they do not get it. And I change the watch batteries for old people and fix phones for teenagers. That is basically my life right now. But to fix a lot of change the watch batteries for a lot of phones, you have to take like an X-Acto blade to wedge it under a little tab on the back of the watch and then pop the back off of it. And a lot of these things are really tiny, so if you slip, you know, you risk cutting yourself. I had apparently hit my thumb unknowingly on one of these instances and actually cut myself. Normally I don't get that deep. And I did not know I cut myself until I then later went to the Winking Lizard and got my typical hot wings for wing night and proceeded to pick them up, eat them, and halfway through the first wing went, holy fucking shit, my hand hurts! Eating chicken wings with only one hand is considerably more difficult because then you're kind of like chasing the chicken wing around your face.
Yeah, I can see that. Completely see that.
So, yeah. But I did get my beer of the month glass, and every year, January, the glass also comes with a hat. So I now have a super legit Winking Lizard hat with, what is it, Boulevard Brewing emblazed on it, and it's got a super legit pom-pom on the top, too. So I'm, like, top class right now. Pretty happy about it.
Speaking of which, hey, Fire, is there any place here in Vegas that does like hold that whole like beer of the month and you keep the glass?
I'm sure there's something out there.
I
know where the spots are back home in California, but I have no idea here in Vegas.
There's no like beer of the month where they keep your glass thing, although my husband is much more knowledgeable on this shit because he's a beer enthusiast.
As I drink vodka right now.
Yeah. No, He goes to a lot of these places, so I don't know what a lot of them have. I do know that World of Beer is almost right next to us, and they would have what is the most similar. But it's not really the same thing. It's more like a point system. You drink this beer, we give you points, you get stuff. It's not exactly the same. But
honestly, your best bet is find a brewery in the area and just go to it. Most breweries have their own stuff to it, and even if you're not like, hey, for the purchase price of this beer being a little more expensive than the others, you get to drink it out of a special glass and then keep the glass, you can use pretty much every brewery has, you know, at least small gift shop option, even if it's just like a few things behind the bar that you can buy souvenir wise that you can get stuff like that. The place we went to in Chicago had the same thing, and I'm just now remembering that I was supposed to have purchased a glass from them before I left the city, and I forgot to do that, so more reason to go back later and get that.
Now, if you want to know where the majority of new breweries are, in the Las Vegas Valley. They're all in one conglomerated area in Henderson. They did it on purpose, one of them being Bad Beat Brewery. And it's right off of Eastgate Drive behind the auto show, auto mall. If you go on Eastgate Drive there, which is right behind the auto mall, turn right into the commercial area, and there's like five or six breweries right there. Yes, Bad Beat is one of them. Hmm. And they do a collaboration with a coffee shop here called Bad Owl, and it's a Harry Potter-themed coffee shop, and it is my heaven.
Huh. Yeah, because I'm only familiar with the ones around Summerlin, but that's about it.
See, the real answer to this whole dilemma is you just need to fly out to Cleveland to hang out with me, and I will take you to the Winking Lizard, where we have the world tour of beers.
I'll fit into my schedule. Don't worry.
Damn straight you will, son.
I'll get that tax-free money and deployment and just come back and be like, all right.
There you go.
Time to go to fly and drink beer.
Yep. All you need to do is drink 100 beers within the calendar year, and you get a super spiffy jacket and invitation to an exclusive party. And some other cool swag.
Just 100.
Just 100.
All right.
Unique beers. They all have to be different.
Yeah, that's how the world of beer is.
Challenge accepted.
So yeah. Good.
And but the world of beer is closer. It's in the Galleria Mall in Henderson.
But Shro isn't there, so it's just not very cool.
But he could be.
That's true. So you're paying far. For it, right?
Are
you paying for us to go out there?
Maybe I'll pay for your beers. 100 beers is a lot of money.
Cheaper than airfare.
That is actually how I went to Chicago. My friend Tom, who's a childhood friend of mine, we wanted to go visit our friend Cyrus, who was also a childhood friend and is now working out in Chicago, working and living there. And so we wanted to go see him, and there just happened to be a, you know, event that Tom wanted to go to too, that was the last of the year out there. So we decided, fuck it, let's plan it all for the right time. He put all the planning together and used the fact that he is a super awesome programmer and gets paid well for it, and just bankrolled the entire trip, including my own stay and expenses, other than like food, with the condition that I was the one that drove and used my car. I'm like, okay, I like driving, and I like driving my car. Drive 6 hours one way to go both ways, and you pay for the entire trip? Sold.
Did he pay for gas?
Yes. He paid for the tolls, he paid for gas, he paid for the Airbnb, the transit tickets, and some of the meals, and what the hell else did we do?
Totally off topic. What's the difference between a B&B and an Airbnb?
Airbnb is like a service.
Think of an Uber.
Yeah, it's a like, company.
Yeah, think of a like Airbnb being like the Uber of B&Bs.
Yeah, kind of. It's basically a company that helps organize people that would like to turn their private property into a bed and breakfast kind of idea on an invitation kind of system, and it helps facilitate that versus a bed and breakfast that is actually a, you know, intentional company.
Oh, just a side note, just wanted to know.
Yeah, no, it's a fair question. It rides that similar sketchy area of Lyft and Uber and all that, of commercializing and socializing, like social media-esque a little bit, of services that didn't normally have any such fling to them and are somewhat regulated too. Like Uber and Lyft have constantly brunt against the taxi services, because services have to go through regulation and insurance and training and special purchases and licensing, and Uber and Lyft just like, we don't feel like doing that.
Hey, can you drive? Yes. Well, come drive for us. That's basically it. Airbnb.
And they really dick over some of the people that drive for them, too, which is funny.
Yeah, and Airbnb is racist. Or can be. Very racist.
Yeah, that too.
I'm going to sleep, guys.
Nonsense!
Not a lot.
Night, everybody!
Hi, Katie.
Bye.
It's too early. It's only 9:04.
Exactly. It's only 9:04.
My fancy new watch does a world time, so I can tune into every time zone on the planet.
Essentially time traveling.
A little bit. At least my watch is. It kind of just does it without me, and part of my wrist just kind of phases out of existence for a moment, and then it comes
back. Speaking out of existence and segueing back to video games. That's a horrible segue.
Yeah.
You stopped playing Eve?
What?
You stopped playing Eve again?
No, I'm still in it, like, hardcore.
I know.
I'm loving it.
Anyways, what were you saying?
No, I'm just... We're completely off topic, but anyway.
Do we really have a topic? I don't think so.
Nah, we don't have a schedule or notes.
What's the topic?
It's completely ad-libbed.
I was just roaming on video games.
I have a giant ad-lib, and you guys keep saying verbs and nouns, and I've been slowly filling it in.
Let's just keep going off topic about how we were off topic.
I mean, we can ADD really fun. We've done it before.
Yeah, we
do it all the time.
I mean, somebody asked me, what's the IA podcast about? And I'm like, well, it's kind of supposed to be like an opinion discussion thing on recent gaming events as well as community events on it. But we kind of ADD the fuck out of it, too. So kind of everything.
A little bit from column A and a little bit from column Z25.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Z25.
And then back to B12.
All the
B12. Little bit of column A all the way through column A.
Hey, you sunk my battleship.
A little bit of
how did you even know it was there? That's not even on the map.
The little column A, little column B reminds me of that episode of Archer.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then I just saw Netflix. They have a new one of, I don't know what they're calling it, Pacific Heat or something like that.
I am unfamiliar.
That's the same principle, but not cool. Not funny.
Oh. That's unfortunate.
I'm confused how far behind my stream is for the game.
You're streaming a game?
There we go. The hockey game. I'm like a minute behind from live television.
Right.
It's like everyone was mentioning, like, we tied it up. And I was like, has it happened yet? How far am I behind?
Gotcha.
Reddit game day thread.
I don't try to read those things. My
it's where I get all my karma.
Ugh. Right. No, I get it. my friend JP does the same thing for the baseball games and basketball games out here. And it's funny because I'd go over to his place and I was basically like fixing his car and a few other things and teaching him how to be like the handyman kind of man. While he then interns, once the sun sets and I couldn't do any of that anymore, we'd come inside and we'd watch whatever relevant sports game was playing, and he'd do the same thing with the Reddit streams and change all that and basically be teaching me how to sports as a man. And so it's like our way, instead of punching each other's man cards, we're like teaching each other like different parts of being a man that we're bad at because Shro can't sports to save his life. And
I'm getting the hang of like every single sport and like what the rules are. But if I play, I just have terrible coordination. I get made fun of.
Yeah, no, if there's a ball and a stick involved in it, like I can't play it. It just doesn't happen.
I can't believe what am I supposed to do? So we have a ping pong table at work and I'm just like, I'm so bad at this. And they have a tournament going on before our guys deploy. I'm just like, I keep losing.
Yeah.
I'm better with my least dominant hand than my dominant hand. That's how bad I am.
I've played a little bit of ping pong, and I think that like three times that we ever had an actual volley happen were the best points of the whole game, because it wasn't just somebody serving and the other person hitting the floor. No, Squaz, you want to be real upset with me in this? I'm watching the World Series. Cleveland Indians are in the World Series. And we got robbed of a 3-championship win in a single year of our hockey team, our basketball team, and our baseball team being in the World Series. Despite
which is
your team? Huh? What?
What's the team?
We're the Cleveland Indians.
Okay.
So the World Series this year, that everybody was super excited about the Cubs, never, you know, won a World Series in like 100 years or whatever it was. Well, as the rest of the world was like, oh my God, the Cubs are in the World Series, Cleveland was also sitting there going like, yeah, we're in it too. Hi. Yeah. Hi.
You guys are like the Ronda Rousey fight.
Yeah, like, pretty much.
Everyone just focus on Ronda Rousey and not the Nunes chick.
Right, who kicked her ass.
48 seconds.
Oh my God.
Putting it on Instagram.
Yep. So that whole time, this super crazy high profile game, my favorite parts of it were realizing that when the catcher needed a new ball for whatever reason, all he had to do was put his hand over his shoulder in an upturned position, and the umpire just pulled a ball out of a giant bag he had on his hip and put it in his hand for him. And this happened so quickly, without fail, that I just started referring to the home base umpire as the ball dispenser and making TF2 references the whole time, going, need a dispenser, need a ball here, because just umpire, or the catcher just put his hand up, just ball, suddenly. It's just magical. You don't even see the umpire go for it or anything. There's just a ball in the dude's hand all of a sudden. Like, this is fucking great. I don't know why I was so incredibly entertained by that, but that was my sports. That was baseball to me for the World Series. You
get entertained by the weirdest thing, Shro.
I do. But I figure right now Squall is like cutting himself, and that's why he's silent, because he's just like, I can't be friends with him anymore.
We can't be friends.
He's probably got a baby spitting up on his shoulder. Don't mind him.
Yeah,
no, he is. Which is unfortunate, because I was going to make him go off on Eve, since we brought up Eve. Squaz, for those of you that haven't listened, has been dying to talk about the fact that Eve has gone free-to-play, and what that means in the Eve universe, as well as all the rather never-ending numerous stories of new players coming to the Eve universe having no idea what they're in for, and getting raffle-stomped into oblivion. Even after being warned about, you know, don't do X, Y, and Z, and somebody goes and does X, Y, and Z, and then posts about it on the internet when they get their ass kicked for it, and the whole internet basically just sits there and says, we told you, in the game, out of the game, at the same time, not to do it, and you did it. And
do this.
There's apparently just like a never-ending occurrence of this happening, because there's just enough new people that one person learns their lesson, and then the next person makes the same mistakes. So, good times. Maybe at some point we'll get to do that kind of a thing. Miss Firetits, are you in Vanilla WoW?
No. I'm in other WoW, because I already pay for it, and I didn't want to put two copies of WoW on my computer.
That's true. Squaz, because we were just...
with one copy of WoW on my computer, plus Guild Wars, it went... So, I didn't need to do two.
Hey, at least the other one is really old WoW.
It's only like 5 gigs compared to the like retail WoW, which is like 35.
Hey,
gigs.
that was a huge number back in the day, man.
Oh, it definitely was, yeah. But I'm just saying, like compared
now
to
that's like a patch.
Yeah,
now that's like a patch. I love it. It's sad but true.
It's like,
what was it? The Overwatch Christmas patch was like 1.5 gigs. I'm like, Jesus Christ, that was like a third of the install size. Squaz, if you're back, we were just talking about Eve and the new players coming into Eve and how you really, really wanted to talk to us about that.
And sports.
And sports. Sports!
Go team! It's like that GIF that's like, go team sports. Let me find it.
I was going to say sports ball. I like that sports ball game.
That's funny.
But throw the ball. It's a sport.
Throw the ball, kick the ball, punt the ball, spike the ball. Ball the ball, be the ball, dodge the ball.
Found it.
Not it.
There you go.
There was a game we used to play in high school that I actually rather enjoyed. We called it Point Break. And it was basically dodgeball, but we played it in the gym that had the basketball hoops that were like the quarter-sized and half-court size. So the hoops were actually on what would have been the sides of a normal basketball court. And So how it worked is you'd play dodgeball, and if you made a basket on the other team's side hoops, so you had to make like a 180 swish shot because there was no backboard. If you managed to get one of the dodgeballs through the hoop that way, then you got your team members back on the court. You also had a bowling pin. Oh,
there's so many variations of that.
Right. And then you had a bowling pin for both teams that you could choose to guard or not. But if at any point the bowling pin for your team was knocked over, you immediately lost, no matter how many people were on the court still. So, I don't know. It provided some unique strategy for it. It was easily the most fun I had in gym class because that was the one thing I could actually also be kind of good at was being the point guard. No, I wasn't the cherry picker. I was the guy that was the target for the cherry picker because the good strategy for it was you would dedicate somebody to be the defense. And since you can block a ball by using a ball as per normal dodgeball rules, then when your team started, the first person to get a ball for your team would hike it backwards to the guy at the pin so they could use it to block any incoming shots for the pin. And then if you had a really good team, the guy would try to block those shots in such a way that they popped in the air so that one of your teammates could catch the ball and get the guy that threw it out. Hmm. It was a lot of fun.
It's different.
Also, I'm slightly concerned by the fact that Dude Run has linked a video that A, has the word Fatuba in it, and B, the thumbnail says press A to pound the ingredients.
Oh my. I'm not surprised. That seems like a very...
Apparently this is something from Pokemon Sun and Moon.
Oh, yep.
Okay. In that case, yeah. I'm surprised.
There's a scene where you have to... We gather ingredients to lure out this one Pokemon, and you have to mix the ingredients together. But once you do that, the game goes first person, and you're staring at this girl in first person as you pound the ingredients together. It's like, pound it, grind it, turn it to goo, and then, yeah. Big masturbation joke right there. Doing like a scent that goes around the area.
That was special.
Yeah.
Wow.
Mm.
Little concerned now.
Me too.
Oh my god. I forgot about this GIF Explorer. Yes, I said GIF.
Graphical interface.
Time. Sports. Touchdown.
Sports. Yes. Backflip.
That is basically sports.
I guess that actually, because is that a frisbee that they rolled, or yeah. Is that yes. An actual ball?
That was a frisbee.
That is a frisbee. That was actually, so my sports that I did in high school and college were cross country and long distance track and ultimate frisbee. So I was that level of a nerd. I played fucking frisbee as a like semi-professional thing. We had a team in college, and granted, it was really a student club because it was that unofficial of a thing, but we actually got together and went to other universities and played ultimate on the football fields at the universities. It was great. For those of you that don't know, ultimate frisbee is basically a sort of soccer football thing, only you use a frisbee, and you have minor movement capabilities because of it. You can, like, take three steps before you have to pass the frisbee, so you can, like, do that sort of thing. But you can totally do, like, handoffs with people, or you can do, like, long Hail Mary throws across the football field, and you have to get it to the other touch, or the other end zone to score. So, it's a good time. So, a lot of the colleges now have the turf fields, and those really suck for something like ultimate frisbee, because you're usually jumping really high a lot and making like crazy dive passes, kind of like American football or rugby, but I guess not in rugby, but in American football you're covered head to toe in all sorts of padding and at least some sort of like spandex kind of uniform thing, which protects you from the fact that fake plastic grass is actually really kind of sharp and uncomfortable. So when you're wearing t-shirts and shorts, which is the normal apparel for Frisbee, tumbling around on that shit, like, you get cut up to hell.
I never played it.
Sounds intense.
Competitive.
Brian, we'll get poutine and then I'll teach you Frisbee.
Yes.
What could possibly go wrong? We'll put poutine on the Frisbee.
Here, catch.
And throw it
to me
in Virginia so I can have poutine.
I had some good throwing passes, but I'm not sure I could cover. What would that be in a straight line?
I don't know. Several hundred miles?
Yeah, I'm thinking like 600 or 700 miles.
Yeah. You can do it. It'll be fine. Just take wind direction into account.
I would only have to throw it into the stratosphere.
You can literally do it.
Man, San Jose is shouting beat LA so loud.
I don't even know what that means.
They always shout that against my team. Because does they that, really don't like us.
What does
it's
that
basically
mean?
North though? California versus South California in hockey right now.
Ah, got it. Okay, that makes more sense. I still don't know what BLA is supposed to mean, though.
Beat Los Angeles?
Oh, where the Kings beat! Are. There's a T yeah. there.
Oh, no,
I'm
I said
thinking
beat.
Literally the letters B, L, and A.
Oh, that works, too. Beat Los Angeles, but yeah.
That's
they
what I thought
us
you said.
An asshole. Ah!
Ha! Huh.
Butt Lovers Anonymous?
I don't yeah. know.
Sure.
Sounds like one of
my How'd you guys find out about my side group? What the hell?
What?
I just knew it. We stalk you.
I find it.
Is this the reason why you deleted your Facebook?
Mm-hmm.
Just because you don't want us to find out?
Exactly.
Well, too bad. We found out.
Damn it!
What else were we going to talk about? There were things I was going to mention.
Well, E3 is this week, if you want to go geeky.
Oh, shit.
Not E3, CES.
No, I would say, wait a minute. E3, no, that's later in the year. You lied to me.
My
you
bad.
Lied, you motherfucker.
My bad. Alcohol.
I need some of that right now.
I have too much here. I have...
I'm slowly building
red
up a stockpile.
Wine, white Ryan.
White Ryan?
4 bottles of tequila.
How much of the white Ryan you had already?
No, I have vodka. I have 2 bottles of vodka.
I can't get vodka because my mother likes vodka a lot, and she steals it from me. I spent about $45 in various bottles of vodka before I finally said, fuck it. I'm not buying vodka anymore. If you want vodka, you can buy your own goddamn vodka.
Just go to Costco, get their $12 vodka.
Well, because I would buy like mid-shelf vodka all the time.
Like
good
what?
Potato vodka, and it was just a... oh god, I don't even remember anymore. I used to know, but it's been years.
Mm.
I did the tequila I was talking about earlier that I got that was really, 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 really fucking good is called Milagro. Highly recommended that. I've never had tequila that was so good, even just straight. Can't wait to actually mix it with stuff.
Yeah, I have 1 normal tequila bottle, 2 coffee blended. Tequila and 1 banana, which I don't know about. Kind of iffy on trying that one. But one of my coworkers gave it to me before I left to Korea.
Hmm.
So I'm like, well, got this bottle now.
One of my things is I've been recommended something. It's a Mexican soda called Jarritos.
Charitos.
Yeah, we see it all the time over here.
And
Vegas, we're very much just north of Mexico, so we can't
right.
call that.
Hardly.
But enough. They think it's like a mini Mexico in some places around here.
Mini Mexico.
Well, if you go like south of Nellis, yes.
Yes, which is the entirety of Las Vegas.
No. North of the Strip, south of Las Vegas is like Mexico. Everywhere else, I think it's not really Mexico. It's just Americanized ghetto.
Wait, Americanized ghetto? Isn't that redundant?
Yeah, a little bit. But I don't know. I get a different vibe being in that like Mexican area versus like the other areas. Like if like even though it's like oh man, it's a Mexican like ghetto. It's still I'm just like well feel more comfortable.
Do you
feel like I actually walk out and talk to people without getting shanked?
Do you feel the need to stand outside of a Home Depot?
Never did that kind of like tool work.
Being very stereotypical. That's
right. I'm part Mexican.
I wasn't even going there,
But sure.
Winston the turkey.
My dog is staring longingly at me from the hallway.
Crying, you're so quiet.
Now she's actually glaring at my sister, which is even funnier.
Oh, yeah.
Stop being quiet, Bryan.
I could try.
Try hard.
Why don't you try hard?
Be a try hard.
There's nothing I can add to these discussions.
Why not, dude? Why not?
I don't go out to places like you guys do. I have no life.
You should fix that.
I should, but I don't have the money to do so.
Just start walking.
Be cheap. Yeah, just walk. No.
Grab your camera, get a good battery charge out of it, put your SD card in it instead of putting it in the computer, and just start walking. It'll be, let's play go outside.
I love it.
Yeah, I don't want to do that. That sounds
terrible. I know the outside is scary, dude.
That sounds like a terrible idea.
Make a like YouTube series, just like, this is my first time going outside.
Oh my god, you should. That would be hysterical.
I need to find a place that's okay with filming. Oh, and I could do that.
Dude, just, like,
I just need to like go
down
to
the street, public parks, as long as you don't like get, you know, people's addresses or faces in it, then you're fine.
Just put a GoPro on you.
There you go. I don't have money for a GoPro.
Then take duct tape and duct tape your camera to your face.
No, give me money for a GoPro and I'll do that.
GoFundMe will work.
I've got a Patreon for that.
It's the stupidest GoFundMe so far.
Save Betty White from 2016 was pretty damn awesome.
Yeah.
That was great. But there was another one I'm trying to think of, but I can't remember.
I mean, I'm sure like 9 out of every 10 GoFundMe are complete bullshit. The popular thing I see, and I don't want to harp on it because, I mean, it is a good cause and I do understand it, but I see a lot of GoFundMes are of such and such pet needs a medical procedure that we can't afford because nobody thinks about pet insurance.
True.
Granted, the pet insurance market is all sorts of screwy, just like the normal health insurance market, but probably best to not start Shro on that particular.
Where the fuck is it? Can't find it.
Up your butt and around the corner.
Just around the corner.
Oh! Oh my god, I saved it.
What did you save?
The goalie is doing really good. He's our backup's backup, and he's doing so good.
Awesome. That was part of our problem with the Indians in the World Series. It wasn't really a problem per se, but the Cubs had like all of their players and the Indians had like three guys out on injury or whatever. And we were still doing really, really well, but doing, you know, backstring lineup. My sister is now in the process of riling up my dog again instead of actually doing anything to help my dog. What else we got?
I'm looking for the dumb crowdfunding. So one of them popped up and was saying, Fund Alabama. It just says, Fund the Alabama State Government. And they got $1,365,000 out of $300
million.
Whoa. Wow.
That's actually more money than I would have expected.
It is. Especially out of 75 people.
It's like we're having fun over here in Ohio with all the people that are like, taxes. Trump's gonna save the world. I want no more taxes. Why aren't any of the roads fixed? And why are there no plows? And like no public services? And I want you know, good emergency responders and to not be firing every fire department. But you need taxes. No, fuck taxes. Okay. Americans are dumb.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, not Americans, all Americans. I mean, you guys are pretty good examples of slightly above average.
Which is just barely above average.
Thank you for the compliment.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Thanks,
Bri. I strive for average.
Same.
It's good to set your goals high.
Yep.
If we could blend in, that's good. We don't make ourselves a target.
Higher chances of survival as long as you're, you know, not somebody that's got a bullseye painted on their head.
It's like this. If you're the average, you're not the weakest link. So you're good.
That makes sense.
Alright, other than gratuitous amounts of furry porn, what else we got? We're not gonna do Henderson for anybody that's looking for Henderson. I probably should have said that in the beginning of the first one. Oh well. I was figure we'll do the Henderson's Director's Cut Part 4 as part of our normally scheduled podcast.
All right. What?
The Henderson Explore, part you'll just have to dial back through all of our previous podcasts to hear about Old Man Henderson.
Hold. Can you hold on for a little while?
It's probably about 27 hours worth of material.
Yeah.
Question mark?
So, can you guys hold?
Yeah, sure. We'll see you in 27 hours.
I'll see you Thursday then.
Yeah, Thursday.
Sounds good.
Or it'll be Friday for me.
Actually, if you want to start from the beginning, I think it's the first 15 episodes are on the website. But we also have all the episodes on our YouTube channel. And the most recent episodes you can find on SoundCloud as well. But we have limited storage on SoundCloud, so we can only put up the most recent ones.
Yeah.
Because SoundCloud is dumb when you have a free account. And I'm saying it.
I've said it before, too.
It's been said.
Dime business.
It has been said.
Yeah.
Dime business.
We all hate SoundCloud's limited ability to store sounds.
I know. Canadians, I have a question for you.
Canadians will respond now.
Do you guys have bidets?
I feel like that used to be a thing, like back in the 80s. You know, before my time, but yeah.
Because
it's still a thing somewhere.
I mean, it's most certainly still a thing. I'm trying to get one because I think it's... Look, I want wonderful cleansing water on my bottle, okay? I'm just going to come out and say it.
Yeah, no, that's fine.
I think it's pretty legit. It's a little weird for Americans to, you know, get over the idea of, you know, not ripping their buttholes apart with scratchy toilet paper and, you know, not being able to enjoy their number two time. And I think a nice water massage on my anus is pretty legit.
Yeah, it only saves on that massive toilet paper if you happen to have sticky shit.
It's economically and ecologically friendly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's true.
But I don't want water up my butt. That implies
that's
something.
Weird.
I guess I've wondered why bidets aren't a bigger thing.
Because it's stigmatized for some reason.
Because it's
humans
water up the
and
butt
Americans and are dumb.
You're straight. You don't want anything touching your butt that's not toilet paper. That too. Yeah. You tell him, puppers.
Good dog. Good dog.
He does bring up some valid points.
It's true. Yeah. And my dog just bowled my sister over in her excitement. I feel like this is karma for my sister winding my dog up.
Definite karma.
Also, keep in mind, my dog is a little 35-pound fuzzball. She is not some giant, huge dog. So the fact that she just pulled my sister over is really funny. Just this long-haired, fuzzy wrecking machine. Anyways, with the sounds of Crazy Puppy in the background, does anybody else have anything to add? Or I think it might be a decent time to
call it a night. Yeah, good time to stop.
We'll chip tune my dog's barking to the fade out song.
That sound. Give me more work to do.
I could probably figure that one out.
You do it.
All right, Sora. I need you to bark more. Come here.
Howl. Just howl.
Yeah. Howl! She's actually not a howler.
Oh, that's disappointing.
I know, right? When you do that, she just like looks at you like, whoa, what the fuck are you doing? You're not supposed to make that noise. I still miss the times at some of my old kind of jobs when we'd start howling circles. You get one dog that would like start doing it, so we'd all start doing it, and I do mean we as in the staff would start doing it, and then you just have like the entire daycare is just a circle of howling dogs. It's pretty great.
Should put on the Zootopia howling dog scene.
It basically is that, yeah.
All right, folks. Well, thank you for joining us for our open mic live podcast of the super long variety and our silly interruptions and meandering. We're looking forward to a good 2017 as America burns because lol. And we'll try to keep...
It's meme magic. It works.
Yeah, yeah.
We memed a guy to presidency. It works.
Oh, God, yeah. Let's
can meme him not even, into doing
Let's things. Not even think about... Oh, we lost a person.
We lost a fire tits.
Rip.
So, we'll see you as our podcast schedule normalizes a bit again. And the gaming news will continue as we play our violins while Rome burns. And the violins will, in fact, be for Guitar Hero 17, because what the fuck Guitar Hero number are we on now? I don't even know.
I don't know.
We're going to have electric violins in the next one. It's just got to be a thing.
Oh, definitely.
But, all right.
Violin Hero confirmed.
Yeah, I know. Violin Hero. I like it. We're doing it. Actually, I'll sign out with one other thing. You know what the first electric, like good electric violins that went mainstream are called? They were popularized and made specifically for Trans-Siberian Orchestra.
Yeah.
What are they called?
Viper violins.
Oh, that sounds edgy.
And they do have edges.
That also sounds edgy.
They look like the crazy, like weird triangular electric guitars of the 80s, but you put them on your shoulder instead of over like your stomach. It's awesome. Anyways, folks, signing out. Dude, push that button. Did you lose the button again?
Yeah. I think.
Do I have to send the dog after you?
I think the dog may have eaten the button. So
she ate the button. Is that why she's barking?
Yeah.
Because the button's in the well? No Lassie references? Okay.
I got it. I was hoping the dog would bark again and then you'd have something to say.
Nothing good. My wit's not that strong, especially at midnight. Or, fuck, it's actually almost 1 in the morning.
Yeah.
This was the late night session.
Oh, yeah.
True Insomniacs time.
So why don't you go hug your dog and then...
Yeah, my doggy needs to go outside.
Okay. I'll just crop out when you find the dog button.
We'll just find more animal noises to put at the end.
We are in Insomniac. Wait, are we still recording?
Yes.
Because dude never actually hits the button.
Oh, okay. Well, in that case, we are the Insomniacs Anonymous. And yes, we are the real Insomniacs Anonymous.
Was there any doubt
to that?
Was there
a fake button?
Yeah, did we make a fake one? What happened here?
Well, you know, there was a bot spam account.
Wait a minute. Do you guys remember the push screenshot? I actually found numerous Insomniacs Anonymouses on Facebook because Facebook tried to tell me to join the Insomniacs Anonymous group. And so then I clicked it out of curiosity one day and it brought up several things that were not us, as well as us. And one of them totally has like a strange, like furry, very furry anthro wolf wearing like one of those Chinese hats like the Pandarians wear that I can't remember their name, like the rice farmer hat, I think is what it's called. Yeah, I need to find this screenshot again.
If you do before I upload it, give it. I'll link it and then it'll be a thing.
That would be funny. Watch us get like a copyright infringement because we stole it from another group.
It wouldn't be on video, it'd be in the description. So there's nothing
that's true.
Anyway, go hug your dog and try to find the button to stop this.
Does that mean if I have to like
just
time
yell
like my dog?
Stop.
Yeah.
Wait. I have a push response for that too.
Yeah.
Stop!